gentlemen, welcome, welcome, welcome. Shut up, Crendor. Welcome to the Co-optional Lounge. I gave you the damn warning. Shut up.
That was way longer than 10 seconds.
Oh, please.
It was longer than 10 seconds.
That was like 14.
That was 10 showbiz seconds.
Of course.
10 Crendor seconds.
You should understand that by now.
I don't follow those rules. I'm a rule breaker, a rebel.
Here's the thing, I'm a liberal.
Welcome to the Co-optional Lounge. Today we will be playing the argumentative absurd argument super fight game, which is not the official title, but you get the idea. This is a game about arguing over who would be the best superhero to defeat a particular supervillain. The superhero is determined by these cards down here, the white cards and the black cards. The white card determines exactly what the superhero is. And the black cards are various attributes of the superhero, some of which are good, and some of which are probably bad. Each player will be pleading their case as to who will be the best superhero to defeat the supervillain, and we will also be playing these purple cards, which are conditions for the fight, and blue cards, which are conditions in which you are... Well, it's actually the location, never mind. It's the location of the play. So, for instance, we will be fighting in a deep-sea submarine or something along those lines, which may very well affect who wins. It's kind of like Cards Against Humanity, only it requires actual creativity and a sense of humor. So, just saying, that game is a humor transplant. You know, that's for people who
and
don't
Mark.
Actually have real humor. They have to get it through cards. That's how it is. If you can tell, I'm kind of getting sick of Cards Against Humanity, but, you know.
No.
So, the way that the villain mode works is that the villain will place his villain down first, and then everyone will place their heroes down to attempt to counter that villain the best way possible. However, there is an opportunity to screw with people, because after you place down your hero and after you have a little bit of an argument as to who's going to be the best, you get to play one black card from your hand either on yourself or anybody else. So, let's say, for instance, the supervillain is made of ice. Along comes Fire Boy, who is literally made of pure fire, and is probably going to do a pretty good job. What if Fire Boy had some kind of disadvantage? Well, you could play that card and you could screw with him, something along those lines, maybe there'd be a perpetual rain cloud above him or whatever, which would make him less effective. The villain acts as the judge for each round, so basically, we can stop the argument whenever we want and declare who the winner is. Whoever the winner is gets a point. We're going to be tracking our points here with our beautifully colored D20s, which Nerdcube doesn't actually have one of. Actually, no, someone changed the color of my dice without me looking.
I don't know who did that. What? Huh?
You are all dicks!
Whoa.
here you go, Dan. I've given you a wonderful dice, and I'm going to beam it there.
They're conspiring already. Maggie
with
Hitler.
Fucking with the colors.
Maggie
what can
Hitler.
I say? Yep. So that's basically the game. The rule set is fairly loose, thank fuck. And I should just, of course, make everybody aware that not only do we swear a lot in this show, but we are also including the red deck. We are including the red deck, the orange deck, and the anime deck.
What?
The red deck is extremely offensive.
Deck.
There's an anime deck. I'm sorry.
Bye,
we're including the anime deck. It's the only way I could get Dodger and Octopimp to get in.
Literally, I was like, did someone say anime?
He did.
Claiming they literally can't hear me due to the music, which sounds like absolute nonsense to me. But never mind, I've turned the music down a little bit.
I've got the FTL background music in the background, so...
I have no music, as I
just
lack
for the record,
well, no,
guys,
enthusiasm. Not, that would
don't play
weird.
Your anime cards against people who don't know the animes, and you'll win.
Which is basically me.
Attack on Titan.
I literally did a sound check earlier, and people are now saying the music's too loud. I don't know how that has actually happened, but fuck everybody.
So
it's screw music.
I will be defaulting to Octopimp for explanations on
like,
anime. I don't know.
I can't hear you over the music. Apparently, there was not even any music. Shut up, chat. Jesus. God damn it.
Thanks, Twitch chat.
It wouldn't surprise me if there's just one guy who has three windows open right now, and that's why it's like too much music. It's like you've got a YouTube video open, jackass. Jesus.
I like it.
All right. Well, I guess we're going to begin then, shall we?
Woo!
Okay.
All right.
Okay. All right. So I guess I'll start as the villain. I mean, that sounds about right. The villain
sounds
will be
right,
indicated
yeah.
by this giant chess piece, because of course it will. Alright, so I'm going to deal the cards out to everybody. So everybody gets three white cards. I'm going to deal to all seated players. One, two, three. And they also get three black cards. 1, 2, 3. All right.
For the record, this white card here and the black card, these are your discard piles in case
those
you
are
guys have not.
The slightly larger cards, oh, okay. you discard onto those. Simple as that. Okay, so as the villain, I choose one white card and one black card from my hand, and I place it face up on the table. And then I draw a random black card from the deck and add it to my supervillain. At which point, you guys then choose your card. So I'm gonna have a look.
God, that sounds so bad.
All right, I bet you can't stop this one.
I bet you're right.
I bet you cannot stop Captain T-Rex, accompanied by a harem of fighter girls.
And let's see what the secondary attribute is.
Shit, I would watch that anime, though.
You would watch any anime, you know that. However, he is also...
He has all the
Dragon Balls.
What? Oh, that's so fierce!
Damn, dude.
I mean, do I just get a point now for just winning?
Yeah.
Like,
that's... You have... What?
Well, don't you need to speak the language to be able to summon
guys,
the dragon?
Panic. Don't panic, because T-Rexes might not make the best choice with their wish, alright? So,
I wish for longer arms! Yay!
Well, now you fucked! That's the only disadvantage a T-Rex has.
I feel like he'd eat all
the
fighter girls.
Off. He'll fall over, he's screwed. Hubris.
So, after the supervillain creates the supervillain, everyone has to, if you are done building your hero, put... the card that you want to be your character card face down in front of you, and then your tribute card face down as well. And then it starts off for the person to the left of the supervillain, which is me, and then goes around the room clockwise, and everyone introduces their hero one at a time. That way you don't spoil what else you have in your hand.
Also, you must name your hero in some way.
Yeah, everyone has to have a name.
If I just drag the card into the play area, will it be face down?
No, you need to face it down.
Yeah, so don't flip it with F.
Before doing
it. This always happens every time. It's like we do a sound check and then Octopimp's three times quiet and then he
Yeah, Octopimp got super. He got super quiet.
I'm upping
quiet.
You now. I'm buffing you up now until you speak. Don't worry
okay,
about
cool.
it.
Okay, cool. All right, thank you.
It's a Windows 10, man. It's Windows 10.
It probably is Windows 10. Yeah, probably. You probably got like effect volume on or something.
All right, I think everyone's got their hero. Okay. So it's Captain T-Rex. My hero is Goku.
Whoa!
I mean, okay.
And I am Goku inside of a giant, and then I have to draw another random
giant
character
robotic
card.
Black card. Well, it's
no,
not
no,
white
it's a,
card, is
no,
it?
No, it's character card.
Oh, is it? Okay, all right.
Inside of a giant robotic creeper. I'm assuming it's a Minecraft creeper.
Minecraft explosive creeper.
Woo!
Okay.
So it just blows up, then.
So you just blows up and lose. All right.
Yeah. No. I mean, I'm Goku. Okay. I'm Goku, though.
Goku.
We're not in the arguing stage yet. We're not
all right. Okay. So what is the name of your hero?
Goku 2.0.
Well, you get minus points for lack of originality.
I don't know Dragon Ball. I'm sorry.
We're going around clockwise. Okay, Octopimp, who is your hero?
Hello, boys and girls.
Hello.
As you know. Welcome to my neighborhood, because I am Mr. Rogers.
Okay.
I'm gonna make you feel very special for getting beat by me, because whosoever holds this hammer will have all the powers of the mighty Thor.
Oh, Jesus.
If there's anyone possibly with more pure of heart, it's me.
Well, then.
I like how you embrace the Mr. Rogers.
He sounds like Bruce from Family Guy, and less from Mr. Rogers.
I'll take it, though. I accept that. All right. Dodger, introduce your hero, please.
Okay, look. Out of all of the possible people who are going to run right into this without really knowing what they're going to do, it's got to be Redneck America. So, Redneck America, not many people know this, but he raises flying monkeys. And he's ready to use them. By golly.
By golly?
By golly.
That's
he's
the name.
Ready to use him.
That's the name of your hero. By golly.
No, Redneck America is my name.
Oh,
his name is Redneck America.
Oh,
I accept
it's Redneck
that.
Redneck America. God.
All right.
Well, I figured if we gotta take down Dragon Balls and a T-Rex, what better than a furry?
Damn.
Okay.
But it gets better, right? You think how could a furry do that with
a shrink ray.
Oh,
of course.
Well, I think I've seen some DeviantArt drawings like that.
Oh my gosh, shut up.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus.
And, name. DeviantArt Pony 487.
Yeah.
That's even worse than my name.
Alright, Cry.
Okay, so we got T-Rexes and Dragon Balls, right? What better than motherfucking muscle? That's not what I meant to put at all. It's okay.
Nice. Nice, Cry.
That's totally.
He's a monk. Barbarian. He's a monk. He flipped it.
It's okay. Cry. I forgive you. You want to know why I forgive you?
Why is that?
Because it's a force of habit.
Hey!
That's a reference to what monks wear. It's called a habit.
I didn't know that.
That was good and obscure.
That's good.
This is why I am master of the universe and the evil supervillain, and you guys suck.
What better than a man of muscle who not only kills but fucks who he kills? I will not only kill you, I will make you my bitch as you are slain. And I was trying for it, but He-Man was already taken, so this is Hey-Man.
This is Hey-Man, okay.
Hey-Man.
Okay, that's pretty hard to top. Dan, what do you got for us? Mr. Nerd Cubed.
Right, it's 2016, there is only one way to deal with any problem, and that is feminist. Young feminism.
God, here we go.
And my feminist is wielding a sword twice their height, because it doesn't matter that that's quite difficult to use, I'll be able to do it anyway. It doesn't matter.
That's reasonable. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and her name is?
Anita.
Of course it is.
Alright. Yes. Completely.
Okay. Alright, so now we must find out the conditions of this fight, and then everyone is able to play a black card either on themselves or on somebody else to sort of screw with it. So we're going to put the conditions out, and then we're going to have a little bit of an argument, see amongst yourselves, to see who is most appropriate. Firstly, however, we are...
Fighters shot out of huge cannons at each other for 1 mile of power.
Alright, so the T-Rex, leading a harem of fighter girls who has all the Dragon Balls, is flying out of a cannon at high speed.
Will you survive that fall?
I mean, I have all the Dragon Balls, I can survive anything.
I mean, you'd die after I shoot.
And we're fighting.
And that's happening in Tokyo, by the way.
Of course
it is.
Anime!
This is anime as fuck here right now. Okay, so those are the conditions of the fight, so bear that in mind. So, who amongst you thinks that you have what it takes to
beat
Captain T-Rex?
I do.
Okay.
I do because I am Goku.
You aren't gonna mess me up at all.
Yeah, but here's the thing: you're out of your environment. You're out of your environment. You're not in America. You're in Tokyo now.
America can go anywhere and fuck shit up.
I'm literally Goku, and I possess all the Dragon Balls.
You're gonna blow yourself up. You're in a creeper.
Maybe it's not the Minecraft creeper. Maybe it's just some creepy nerd that's like sitting on the corner.
No. The second you were like, yeah, it's a Minecraft creeper, you accepted.
I want to know why Dan didn't name himself Triggered, by the way.
Because... Oh, because it would have been better, Dan. Name and Triggered is not, but okay.
I've watched Only Fools and Horses. I know that is a name. Nearly Triggered in that.
I'm literally
a
Goku.
Horse, yes.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is, I am a furry. I'm in Tokyo, my home habitat.
No, I don't think there's a strong furry culture there at all, actually.
How do you know?
If we were fighting on fur affinity, then yeah, you'd be in your home habitat, but we're in Tokyo.
I'm gonna Google whether or not there's a strong furry culture in Tokyo.
Is this one we can do the buffs, by the way?
I'm telling you, there's gotta be.
Well, we're arguing right now.
Oh, I see. Okay, gotcha.
I still trump everyone by the fact that I'm just Goku. Goku can't die. From my limited knowledge of Dragon Ball, I know that Goku is essentially God.
No, Goku has died so many times.
Yeah. I think Goku has died more than anyone else in that show.
Why didn't anyone tell me this before I picked it?
More than Krillin, all right?
Yeah, that's safe.
It's not our fault that you don't know anything about the most common anime in the universe. I mean, we had the pre-show, and you asked what an Evangelion was.
I don't know. I have no idea.
I don't know what that is either.
Yeah, see?
Robin Williams was a fan of Evangelion. That was in a movie of his.
Yeah, Evangelion. And look where that got him. Now he's dead.
I just want to point out I made a horrible mistake Googling furries in Japan, but it's okay because I'm a T-Rex and I can't read.
I also have to say, I think that Cry's at a huge disadvantage because the T-Rex has tons of fighter girls, and it says that you have to mate with them.
Shit,
that's gonna take a while.
It's gonna take forever for you to finally get to the T-Rex.
Now, kids, if you'll recall, who won the ultimate showdown of Ultimate Destiny? Well, you know what? I already won a fight like this, and I think you can do it again.
He beat Chuck Norris.
That's a strong point. He does. That is a very old internet reference.
And not only that, I'm armed with Mjolnir. I am Mjolnir Rogers.
He is, actually, Mjolnir Rogers.
All right,
that's
so I have found my debuff target.
I just keep all picturing right. Mr. Rogers in, like, a Viking outfit.
Okay. peasants. Quiet. I bring this debate to a close. You may now take one black card from your hand and either play it on yourself or on somebody else. And we're going to start with Sin Victor and go around the board clockwise.
Okay. So I am choosing to debuff Octopimp because he makes a solid claim with the old internet meme reference. So he is now Mr. Rogers, armed with Mjolnir, riding a depressed centaur as well.
That's going to slow him down.
If there's one person who can pull someone out of depression, it is Mr. Rogers. What is wrong with you?
No, you can't. That's true. You can't change the. You can't change the ability card.
Worth noting as well that in this current environment, he's being fired out of a cannon, so the speed of the centaur is not actually factored into this fight because it is literally being propelled by gunpowder.
And even though he's depressed, he doesn't have to be like cheered up for that long. Like he can be cheered up for a few minutes and then go back to being depressed.
Yeah, he's still depressed. Exactly. He's not going to listen to Mr. Rogers at all. And they are riding him, by the way.
I'm going to kick your ass from the world of next Friday. All right, let's go.
Your chance.
Okay. I am going to, you know what, I'm a little worried about that furry. That furry is making me...
I'm always pretty worried about that furry, but...
I'm gonna write that furry a post about you.
Only has one leg.
Whoa! Oh, it's an amputation fetish furry. Oh,
oh God, not one of those. Anything but that.
Well.
So there you go.
Shit. Alright, just accept your
strong counter argument there. Trendor at his usual accepting pace here. Alright, okay. Dodger, what are you playing?
So we can also use a card to buff ourselves, right?
We absolutely can, yes.
Or buff the villain as well.
I don't know what this card means, but I'm gonna just decide what it means. I'm also cum blind.
How do you not know what that means?
Hear me out.
I don't even know what that means.
Hear me out.
You keep using that word. I don't think it means what you think.
It doesn't. It doesn't, Duger. It doesn't.
All right. So I'm gonna take this to mean that things that are covered in cum, I just don't acknowledge.
No, that's not at all what it means.
Wow, that's not a
No, hear me out.
That's not at all what it means.
God. My side hurts.
When Cry is busy banging all the spider girls, I'm just gonna straight up and go straight for the T-Rex.
But it's one on one. You're not fighting at the same time Cry is, though. It's just you versus TV.
Cry went first.
There's no sloppy seconds though in the Super Mario.
I'm ignoring them.
I think the point is that you're hindering yourself.
You are. You're.
Okay then. Right. Well, this got interesting in a hurry.
It got
Trendor, what would you like to do?
The element of surprise. I get that.
Gosh, damn it.
I don't even think I can do anything at this point. I just
debuff somebody.
I'm a sad one-legged furry.
I'm just gonna...
I mean, you could also play a card in the villain, but that might...
Hey, I'm just gonna... Oh.
Yeah, you can buff the villain.
I'll give you this, then. Okay. I'm gonna give you a flaming tutu.
I'm not 100% sure this is gonna help.
Think about it, dude.
Okay. Where's the rest of the argument?
That was the entire argument.
Just think about it.
Yeah. It tied the whole outfit together.
Yeah. It's gonna look great. You're gonna be a little hotter, like physically and mentally. And, yeah.
Dodger!
What?
Why?
I'm cum blind.
Okay, all right.
Oh my god.
All right, cry.
Great.
Okay, well, so since I'm just going to be busy fucking a bunch of bitches and probably dying in the process, I'm going to help out who I believe has the most chance of succeeding, and I'm going to counteract Invicta's debuff with the ability for him to fly.
Yeah, right.
You don't even need that centaur. You could just leave it and go off as Mr. Molnar Rodders.
But the centaur flies too, though. That's the thing. It inherits.
Do centaurs fly?
What? Centaurs don't fly.
It does now. It does now with the buff.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Wait. So does that mean that all of the fighter girls that the T-Rex has are also in flaming tutus?
Oh shit!
Yes.
Then I guess
it
does.
Cry, you're
fuck.
Doomed.
That furry's gonna go.
Why would you buff somebody else? Cry.
Furry immediately goes up in flames.
I knew I lost, so I was just giving it to someone else.
Oh, but wow, Cry's gonna get a long.
Yeah, but you should have
burning sensation.
You should have buffed the supervillain then, not somebody else.
I was gunning for Mr. Rogers to win.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
You can
he sold it well. I wanted
day.
Him to win. I wanted this point for him.
Oh, you're my special friend.
We're fascist buddies.
Oh, yeah.
They're both fascist.
Yeah.
Dan, what does the notebook say?
There is no notebook today.
Oh.
What?
There's no notebook anymore. Contact notes. It's unfair.
All right. Anyway. What do you got, Dan?
I've got a present for Mr. Rogers.
Oh, no.
Yes, do it, Dan. Do it.
Mr. Rogers, over in this corner here, Mr. Uh-huh. Rogers is literally wearing beer goggles.
It's not going to be
is that good for you the kid? I don't know.
You can't see anything.
That might
oh,
be
man, he's screwed now. I'm leading a harem of fighter girls. You know, his purity will be tested.
That
especially
also
wearing,
means
literally
the,
wearing beer goggles.
The centaur is as well.
Yeah.
Oh, that's shit. It. You can't
would
trust
anybody,
the beer goggle centaur.
Would anybody respect Mr. Rogers at the end of his show if he's got beer goggles on? Like, actual goggles made of beer.
That's the thing.
He's going to hit so many buildings because he's not going to know where he's going at that point.
He was doing a segment on his show where they go to the beer goggle factory and they show you how it's made. So that's
right,
why he's
right.
wearing the beer goggles.
Here's
what a
the
nice
thing.
Guy.
But he has been wearing them for 16 years now and people have started to question it.
And he's a centaur, is probably very used to drinking, and so that's not going to hinder him whatsoever.
Exactly. See, he's used to it.
Yeah.
Mr. Rogers, you know what? I think Mr. Rogers, he can hold his own. I mean, he was in the Navy.
I'm pretty sure you're not going to be able to control anything or find any sort of sense of direction while literally wearing beer goggles and flying while riding
while riding
a depressed centaur that's also flying.
Operating a depressed centaur while intoxicated.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
For that.
I literally am Goku.
I think we should just give this win to Mr. Rogers.
Yeah, but Goku never dies. He never dies for sure, though. Right?
Anime
characters never truly die, though, right?
The only way he ever comes back is with the Dragon Balls, which the T-Rex has.
Yeah,
it seems fairly obvious that Sin Victor's never watched an anime before.
I haven't.
Here's the thing. I'm a liberal.
You're not. No.
That's not a superpower.
Yeah, Grendoge.
Oh, I thought it was.
What? No.
All right, Mr. Villain.
You have to stretch it. Like, here's the thing. I'm a liberal. You need the dramatic pause for effect.
Yeah,
it sold me. I think he's legit.
All right, super villain. I think our debates are done.
I win. Right. Easy.
Well, let's see. It's a tricky one. I mean, normally I would say Goku, but, you know, as he's made abundantly clear, he's inside a creeper. He's going to explode pretty much immediately.
Yep.
So I think he's kind of out of the running at this point. Now, Mr. Rogers, he did win the Ultimate Showdown of Ultimate Destiny. He has basically fought a T-Rex before. He has experience. But considering the amount of horrible things that have now happened to him, I don't think he's in the running anymore. Dodger, I mean...
Yes.
No.
Come blind.
I'm
redneck
America.
Come blind, redneck America.
Well, the furry can't do anything whatsoever because all my guys are wearing flaming tutus, so he'll immediately burst into flames.
You got one leg.
The furry can shrink you, dude.
He shrinks me, but my girls are still on fire. So you're wearing a fur suit. You're gonna immediately immolate yourself.
What if it shrinks you so small, I just step on you?
Yeah, it doesn't matter. My girl's still on fire. You're gonna burn to death.
Yeah, but they'll be really small with fire.
It doesn't matter. Fire is still fire, regardless of its size.
Now when you just step on it, it's gone.
Sure thing, hop along.
Step on all of them at once.
Why not? Yeah, step on really it with small. Your one foot.
Yeah.
No.
Stomp on them. Like
now, as much as I like, something. You know, Cry's idea, is an interesting one. I think he's mostly picking his powers
fuck.
For self-benefit.
Let me bang, bro.
Right on, bro.
Yeah, dude.
And as for Nerdcubed, I'm not 100% sure how this would help.
The feminist can turn your harem of fighter girls against you in midair!
Oh, shit.
I mean, midair!
You do have a point there. You know, she Ooh. Would convince them of internalized misogyny. Yep. They would turn against me, which would be unexpected. A T-Rex doesn't plan for such eventualities. Nope. That... And as a result, I think actually Nerdcubed is the only one who could potentially fight me here.
That the T-Rex would eat the girls.
However, the T-Rex is not a cis white male. It is not even a human at all.
Oh, that's true. The T-Rex actually is higher on the progressive stack.
It is.
So as a result, what would
this
actually
happen... This is a T-Rex that has actually got a harem of fighter girls, though. So I'd actually put it lower than most T-Rexes.
I mean, yeah, but as far as we're aware, the fighter girls are there of their own volition.
Uh-huh.
And he also has all the Dragon Balls, which apparently grant wishes.
I mean, I can also wish for you to go away. So there is
I wish
that.
For feminism to go away.
And Mark, there you go. Only took us 20 minutes.
Basically, my conclusion is everyone is useless here, but the only person that has any experience fighting a T-Rex is Mr. Rogers, so I'm going to give it to Octopus.
Hey!
Ooh.
Good for you.
Boo, you hate women! You
can't
hate women!
Boo Mr. Rogers?
I just
booed
Mr. Rogers. That makes you even worse. Alright, put your white cards on the discard pile, your black cards
I'm
on the
I'm so
discard
amused
pile
that
well.
Argument worked.
We get rid of all of our cards, right?
Correct,
yes,
yeah.
We get rid of all of them.
And that was
That's
round one,
mess.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Can we at least try to be neat? There we go. There is round one.
Wow,
Mr. Rogers wins, which I think is justified.
How do you guys
Mr.
screw
Rogers
the discard up so
spin.
Bad?
I don't know. People are just awful at this.
They put it upside down.
A pile of nonsense. Oh all right. Hang has on. Everyone got rid of all their cards? Because I'll dish out the new ones.
Yep.
This is such
the answer
a...
is no, they haven't at all. At least try. Come on.
I am trying.
I'm trying to
it.
Clean up after everyone's mess here. There we go.
Hey, shouldn't Octopimp have like some kind of marker for a point?
Yeah,
that's what the D20s are.
That's what the dice is.
Oh, that's what they're for.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, they're just all there right. for show, Cry.
Yeah.
One, two, three cards, and one, two, one, three two, cards, three. One, two, and three. The next villain will be Sin Victor.
Ha ha ha! All right. Okay.
Oh, good great.
Remember, he doesn't know anime.
Hmm.
Use all your anime cards.
Overwhelm him with anime.
Just confuse the shit out of him.
Okay, here's my...
That's like Vegeta.
My supervillain. You'll be fighting against... Dumpster Baby.
Oh, God.
Baby.
And his special ability... draw a character card as your 500-pound pet. His 500-pound pet will be a unicorn.
Nice!
Shit, dude. Dumpster baby on a unicorn.
This is some, like, terrible Lisa Frank shit going on right now.
It's a 500-pound unicorn. Alright, my random ability... My random ability is... on bath salts.
I don't even think we need to fight you. I think you're already
yeah,
destroying
I think
yourself.
You're on the way, well on the way.
Okay.
Oh god.
So there's
okay.
your supervillain.
Great.
I'm scared of that.
I have a sweet fucking anime card that I can't play because of you. God damn you.
Oh, the villain name is Dumpster Horn.
Oh, that's not a
terrible.
Good name.
That's
not a good name. You,
okay. This is our judge, everyone. Okay.
Dumpster Horde. Good luck, everybody. All right.
This is an easy one.
I think everyone's got their heroes. Duger, or no, Octopimp, you're up first.
Okay, so my character is Meatloaf. I'm assuming the singer, not the dish. And his top half is drawing another character card from the deck.
Okay, it's a white one. There you go.
My top half is
a liger.
Wow, meat nice. Liger.
What? Will you make me so happy for the rest of my life? Will you take me away? Will you make me your liger?
His name was Robert Paulson.
Exactly. So I'm meat liger.
So confused right now.
Meat liger. Don't worry about it.
That's delicious.
Florida baby. All right. That's my surname, well, Florida baby.
Look, there's only one person who can wrangle a baby, and that's a fucking mom.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
That's true.
And this mom is writing a...
Pick an internet cat.
Oh, shit.
Oh, there's so many options.
There's no cats on the internet.
Dude. My own. She's riding Sherlock, who is also fat, and will be able to compete with this unicorn.
It's basically just a soccer mom riding a house cat, in other words.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what's the name? What is the name of your
school that baby?
Okay.
Baby mama.
Great. Okay. So Grand moving Doge. On. I have two Mormons on mountain bikes.
Okay.
And draw a new character card with one new attribute as your sidekick.
Yeah, so you have to draw one white and one black card.
All right, so yeah, one white.
The sidekick for black. The Mormon.
So the Mormon sidekick will be secret agent, has an enormous exposed breast. This is great. This all works together for my plan.
Great. Yeah.
That's gonna be very distracting for a baby, I guess.
That's going to be very
food.
Distracting for the Mormons.
For the Mormons, food, I was going to say.
Oh,
that baby's going to want to get the food from the breast milk.
Okay. And what is the name of your hero, Grindoge?
My hero's name is... well, he has to be two names. It's like, there's two Mormons. So maybe,
Mormons and Mammaries.
All right, so it's Cry's turn, right. Yeah?
On Cry.
It's just assassin covered in spikes.
Uh-huh.
I mean, there's two Mormons that teamed up with a secret agent with exposed breasts over there, and you're like, no, I brought an assassin with some spikes.
And what is the name of said hero?
Spanky from Little Rascals.
Spanky from Little Rascals?
Yeah.
Okay.
I haven't seen the Little Rascals in, like, a long, long time.
That's still more anime than I've watched, though.
Little Rascals is my favorite.
Little
anime.
Rascals?
Yeah.
Best anime.
Ori in the House is a little better, but that's like true. Number two. Yeah.
All right, and Dan.
I have brought along, dun-dun-dun, an octopus.
Okay.
But it's in stealth mode.
Decoy
but basically,
octopus.
Basically, octopuses can actually change color depending on the background, so basically all I brought along is an octopus.
So he's literally just an octopus.
Its name is Octopus.
Right.
Yeah.
Like my cat named Cat.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Wait, can we see what TB's cards were? Can we please flip them?
Yeah. TB was Pikachu.
Pikachu, great.
That has a magical unicorn horn. That would have been a direct counter to what I have, because I have a unicorn, so...
It would have countered your unicorn, but I don't know about the baby. That baby's got bath salts.
Yeah,
that baby does have bath salts. Yeah. It's ready to go.
Prepare to have your face eaten. Okay, so, now I'm just gonna... I'll discard TV's hero so we don't get confused. Now we have to find out exactly where we're gonna be fighting. So I'm gonna turn over the situation card and the location card. Everyone will be fighting in... Fighters swap all attributes.
What?
What?
So
no, next one. That's dumb.
So you're gonna.
What?
No, we gotta.
So whoever fights me will now be on bath salts, with a 500-pound unicorn.
The octopus comes through. Yes.
And we'll be fighting. We'll be fighting in. On pins and needles, literally on pins and needles.
Octopus. Octopus. Octopus.
Wait, Wait, so I'm confused. I thought that that card meant that we would have to discard ours and then pick new ones.
No, the fighter swap all attributes, meaning that it's since it's a one-on-one, so it's a superhero versus a supervillain, the superhero and supervillain swap attributes.
Oh, that's perfect. Okay.
Yeah, so so now you have to buff and debuff based on the fact that you are now...
It's your stuff.
You have to counter your own hero now.
All right, that's easy. I already counter it with my Mormonism.
So you can state your claims now before we begin the buffing and debuffing.
All right, so listen up. I'm Spanky from Little Rascals because I spank babies. I'm an assassin. I don't care. Uh-huh. I would fuck you up. I'm covered in spikes, but that don't matter because I would have a unicorn apparently. So who cares? I'm still going to spank you, baby.
Okay.
Wow.
Bitch.
Wow.
Great. So would I also be fucked up on bath salts?
Yes.
Yeah.
You basically inherit everything but my character card. So whenever the buffing and debuffing phase starts, keep that in mind that you are now going to have a 500-pound unicorn as your pet.
I wouldn't want to be near Meatloaf normally. When he's messed up on bath salts, everybody watch the fuck out, because he's like a wrecking ball on a 500-pound unicorn.
Angry moms are terrifying. And this baby was a dumpster baby. It's looking for someone to give it purpose. And this soccer mom, who is super hyped up on bath salts and riding a giant unicorn now, is gonna be like the mother figure that this baby wants. Let's be real.
Here's the thing. These two Mormons on mountain bikes, obviously very fit, are now going to have the power of bath salts. They're gonna become insane.
You've tried cycling on bath salts.
Yeah.
They're gonna be like crazy. They're gonna get like superpowers practically from these bath salts before they fall over and die. But in that process, we'll be switching. I'll have the unicorn, you'll have the secret agent with enormous exposed breasts. The baby's gonna get distracted by those breasts and start feeding, and that's when I can take advantage and take it down. Easy.
I'm not sure. I've got an octopus on bath salts while a baby's in stealth mode, but it's a dumpster baby, so it's in a dumpster, so I know where to find it. And I've googled, do bath salts affect octopuses? And there doesn't seem to be any information on that, so probably not.
Why would they...
However, I did find the headline, Octopus Garden Owner, Employees Charged in Drug Raid. So I assume someone was experimenting with it. But there are no results posted yet. So
honestly, it's
questioned. We don't know.
I think that Spanky is our biggest threat right now. Because mm-hmm. we are fighting on pins and needles, and Spanky mm-hmm. is covered in spikes. They're going to cancel each other out. Those pins and needles aren't going to do nothing.
Not a damn thing.
That's how it works.
That's like, totally how it works.
That's,
yep.
Okay. We'll now begin the buffing and debuffing phase, starting with Octopimp. You can now buff yourself or debuff one of your fellow heroes or buff the villain.
Okay. So
remember, buffing the villain would help you out.
Yep.
Yeah, because it would
help
it
everyone out.
That would also help everyone out. The swap of all attributes card is so meta right now, it's blowing my mind.
Yeah, that's really strange. Okay. You know what? I'm gonna give the villain, and in effect everyone else, a beard of bees.
Oh.
Everyone's got a beard of bees.
That baby has bees on its face?
No, you do.
Yeah. It's a yeah.
Oh, we do, because
well,
we're
for right now
attributes.
Until the fight. Until the fight, the baby has beard on its face.
Yeah, it's a bee baby.
Beard on its face.
It's a beard on its face.
Bees.
All right, Duger.
Okay. I am going to duplicate one opponent attribute onto myself.
Okay.
And it's going to be having enormous exposed breasts.
Okay.
And when I swap with the baby, the baby has breasts that are literally the size of its body. And it
what?
Just can't
That's some
do anything.
Weird Japanese shit.
This is becoming an anime.
Yep.
I'm actually not the official host of this, so I can't duplicate that card. So I'm just going to like put it like in between you and Krendor, just so it...
Oh, it's fine. Yeah. Don't worry. I'll remember what card.
Right.
All right, Krendoge.
All right. I'm going to give myself a Phoenix Feather Wand.
Damn.
Yeah,
but you'd be pretty strong, dude.
You're giving... Okay, so you're going to give it to the baby, and you're using it against yourself.
Oh, shit!
So you basically all right, buff...
All right,
shit.
Whatever, I give up this round.
Okay, cry.
So we're talking meta here. How about eliminates all attributes in this fight? Now I'm just straight up an assassin killing a dumpster baby. I think I got this.
Oh,
So it's just an assassin versus a dumpster baby. All
yeah,
right.
I think I got this.
It's down to Dan to take Cry out because he has the most compelling argument right now.
That is a compelling argument. That is a compelling argument. But I can't do anything because whatever I give him will immediately be destroyed.
Correct.
By his eliminate all things.
Yeah,
so we have to beat him. Yeah, that assassin's going to kill that baby. That assassin's going to kill that
It's only
baby.
Attributes, though. So, like, if you give him, like, say, is only 3 feet tall or something, that won't eliminate that.
I don't have his only
Look,
3 feet
guys,
tall.
We just have to defeat the baby. It doesn't mean we have to kill the baby.
Oh, I'm killing
it's
the
all...
baby.
I get that you want to kill the baby.
I'm
going to
assassin.
What I'm saying
that's
is,
my job.
I think that I can defeat the baby with love, is all I'm saying.
Thank God Cry didn't pull that necrophilia card this turn. I'm just
oh,
saying.
God.
I'm just saying.
Oh, God.
All right, Dan.
I got a thing. And this is going to go on the baby, so this will affect people.
Okay.
People, where's the baby? There's the baby.
Right here.
There we go. Rotate. There we go. The baby, and therefore everybody else, is really hangry.
Hangry?
Hangry.
Yes,
angry.
It's when you're so hungry you are very angry. You're now fighting an angry baby.
Okay.
Actually, you become angry. Yeah. Oh, God, this round's confusing my ass. All I pulled in this fight was an octopus, goddammit!
I just found
it in an aquarium. It nice. I'm here. I just wanted to show you guys.
He literally
I thought
just...
we were doing secret Hitler. I didn't
know. You can't show it to us. It's in stealth mode, duh.
We can't even see it.
The baby's in stealth mode. I don't understand.
We can't even see it. All right. Well, I think it's clear. Even though I like Krendor's reverse psychology, I don't know what a Phoenix Feather Wand actually does. Dodger made a compelling case by a distraction tactic, but you have to actually defeat the baby. And
yeah, I would defeat the baby by being the mother that it needs, and it can't get away because its boobs are so big.
But maybe he was dropped in the dumpster by a mother who had also large exposed breasts.
Oh yeah, think about that.
So
right?
Wait, so the baby took the breasts and put them on its body?
This is Binding of Isaac.
He
now.
Inherited the breasts from its mom.
It comes.
Him.
Yeah, and who is gonna accept that baby? Everybody's gonna be like, "This baby is weird as fuck." Not Soccer Mom. Soccer Mom's gonna be like, "Any baby can be my baby."
As long as it plays soccer.
As long as it plays soccer, we're good.
It comes down to Ligerloaf versus just a regular assassin. If we understand that Ligerloaf is gonna be riding. Well, first of all, he's on bath salts, and secondly. We don't know
doesn't
if...
Doesn't it become Liger Baby, then?
No,
yeah,
it's...
That's a Liger...
No, it's Liger Loaf. You don't inherit the baby card. The baby card is separate. It's only the attributes. It's
oh,
only
okay,
the attributes.
I see.
Yeah, so it's Liger Loaf, who's really hangry, and also has a beard made of bees, who's also on bath salts. It's either that versus just straight up an assassin.
Dude, he's not going to be able to focus on bath salts.
Listen.
He's going to want to eat people.
Yeah.
I read a book one time, Meatloaf has eaten a baby. He'll do it again.
Well, despite that... I'm still going to give it to Cry because Cry is. It comes down to Cry. It's just a straight up. He's not distracted. He's not riding anything. He doesn't have to worry about controlling his hangerism.
Mm-hmm.
So I officially give the point
up
to Cry.
An assassin killing a dumpster baby. That's all
there
it
you
is.
Go.
No fluff. Just killing that little baby.
There you go. So congrats, Cry. You may award yourself a point.
Thank you. I deserve this baby killing point.
This is a weird game.
Have you ever played this before, Dan?
No, I literally went out and bought it today. I saw it and I was like, oh, that looks interesting. And then now we're playing it.
So. Well, this is super villain mode, so it's slightly different than the base super fight mode. But I like villain mode better because it's not... You just don't have two people debating against each other. All the heroes are actually fighting each other instead of like a one-on-one. So it's more fun.
If I'd known that, I wouldn't have bought a bloody octopus to this fight.
Well, you did, so...
I did.
I was sent this game, like, 2 years ago from the developers, and I never actually played it because, like, I don't
so
have
fun.
Friends. to play it with because it was the real card game version of it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you were actually sent the physical game.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know how...
Like, this box in the middle right here, I have that box in my loft.
That's awesome.
And I don't know what to do with it.
That's the best part about this thing, is it's like, all right, I can just play board games on the internet like a normal person.
You know, they're actually... I know it's a terrible idea to bring it up, but they're doing VR implementation to Tabletop Simulator. So,
how does your right hand feel about that?
Oh, it hurts like a bitch. I can't move my index finger at all. Really?
So, okay.
That's fun.
So the villain is now Octopimp, and Cry awarded himself a point. So I guess I'll just go ahead and deal for everybody. And three cards are going to be sent to the void from TB, but we'll just have to deal with that. All right. Good round, Cry. I liked your strategy there.
It's just straight up brutality, man. Don't gotta go fluff about it.
All right.
Wow. Okay. Hmm. All right. So I am a vicious werewolf.
Ooh. Okay.
Armed with a PMS ray.
Damn.
Does that mean that it
any
gives
female?
Us PMS?
Yes.
Would that only work on males or on females?
No, I think
or
it works on both.
Everybody.
And what is the
everybody gets PMS. Shit,
and then I get a random attribute, right?
Well, yeah, well, you have to name your hero first and then you get it.
Let's see.
Villain, I guess.
Villain, yeah, sorry.
Oh god, if only you were a vampire, there could have been like a
real Blood Moon.
Blood Moon's good.
Blood
Moon.
That's
that's
fucked up.
I love it.
It because it's a period joke.
Hey! Alright, so then I get a random attribute.
Yep.
Alright,
no, that's a character. That's a character card.
Never mind.
I'll get it.
I can turn into any vehicle.
Okay.
Oh.
That's not how werewolves work.
Apparently Blood Moon works like that.
Yeah.
Blood Moon works like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right,
I can turn into a tank, into an all-terrain vehicle, scooter,
okay.
Anything.
Okay.
So heroes, build your hero to combat Blood Moon.
So many good ones.
I gotta do this one, no doubt about it.
Twitch chat's like, I'd watch that anime, thank you.
Oh, absolutely.
The Blood Moon
I
anime.
Had it until the vehicle card was drawn, now I'm like, fuck.
I think I've got a good one here. I'm waiting for Dan's attribute card.
I'm thinking.
We could put TB's cards into the deck again, just so they're not completely lost.
We can't, oh, we can't, we can drag them.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I didn't realize I could actually do that, sorry.
What about these ones to the side of me? They're just sitting there.
Oh, yeah!
Just hanging out.
Wait, who
they
was-
They have been sitting there.
Who was sitting there?
We dealt for my octopus, but it's fine.
No one was, I don't think.
Yeah, just put them in the discard, it doesn't matter, I can just shuffle them.
Yeah.
Hey.
Okay, go ahead, Duger, while I clean up this area.
Okay. So,
right, what do you
Blood
got
Moon.
For me?
Blood Moon is impressive and all, but I am Cthulhu.
Oh!
Okay.
I am an eternal, limitless being that will drive you to the very madness that lingers deep in your soul. And I also have little claws that come out of my hands when I want.
This guy,
Yeah, you know, sometimes you just want like a little goof, so you go shing.
What is the name of your superhero dodger?
Beauty Cthulhu. Ching.
That's pretty cute.
I would definitely watch that anime now.
Oh yeah.
All right, Crendoge.
I am Leroy Jenkins.
Oh.
Okay.
And I'm actually giving birth to a
random character card.
Oh. Butt baby.
Giving birth.
Ready.
Spartan. Oh, shit!
That baby's gonna throw down.
Tonight we dine on chicken!
Yeah, but you haven't...
As you run in.
What?
Yeah, but you haven't actually done... Like, that. Your power is... It's while you're giving birth.
Yeah.
That's yeah, you're kind of fucked, actually.
Yeah, you're kind of busy.
And you're going to have PMS.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Sorry, I'm
already problems. Have PMS.
I'm getting ahead of myself.
Like, I'm already, like, going... right?
All
right,
cry.
Can you understand how that works?
I don't understand the female anatomy. So
God, all right, cry.
All right, so
I thought when you're pregnant, you have like crazy hormones, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's practically like PMS.
We've all been pregnant at least once, so
at least. Okay, so Blood Moon, you're very intimidating. All right, and I know the one thing that will chill you out. It's mm-hmm. your mom. So you wouldn't hurt your mom, would you?
That's true. Blood Moon.
Also, I know how to get around you. I can control hair, and you covered in hair.
Oh, that's good.
Alright, what's the name?
You ain't gonna hurt your mama. You ain't gonna be getting anywhere. If you snap at me, I'll sling a hair and make it slap you, okay?
I turned into a big hairy jet, try to get away, I can't do it.
What is the name of your superhero cry?
Blood Mama.
That's good.
I like it.
Aw, Blood Moon and Blood Mama. I bet they're gonna join forces in the sequel.
All right, Dan.
Okay, right. So I brought along a moose because I thought this was just I thought this was a zoo thing.
Okay.
And this moose has literal jazz hands.
So you're
both of your heroes have been so good.
Yeah. Actually, what I'm thinking, right, is first of all, I was thinking if like jazz hands are shaky hands, but a moose can't like hinge that way with its elbows. I don't know if moose have elbows, so it's like hands are shaking in the ground, so its face will smash into the ground, then its face will start shaking. Basically, it's got like blender going on with its
antlers. Spaghetti.
But I just think its hands are playing some soft jazz music.
It's literally just a moose having a seizure.
Yeah. That's kind of what's going on there.
Epileptic moose, that makes me worried.
It's the worst.
It's not even music being played either.
It's the worst.
It's just sad.
Yeah, it's just a moose.
Alright, well my counter to Blood Moon is going to be a cowboy.
Okay.
Armed with a super glue fire hose. So screw you and all your vehicle transformations.
Oh. Think about that getting in the hair.
My hero's name is Sticky Ricky.
Oh,
okay. All right. Okay. Is he cum blind?
No, he's not. I hope not. Anyway, okay. Let's find out what we're gonna be.
Who isn't? Am I right?
Anyway.
Yeah.
All right. Scenario is: all players draw and play a new character card from the deck of the sidekick.
Yes.
All right. Let me deal. I'll deal one to everybody.
Make sure you play that one.
Wait.
Yes.
What is it?
Yes.
It should be the last white card.
Oh my god.
Yes.
Wait, so this is all of our sidekicks?
Yeah, we all have sidekicks now. I have a giraffe.
I have the fucking Prince of Saiyans Vegeta.
Oh shit.
Damn.
And the scenario is a location. We're in the Vatican.
I brought a porn star along. That's gonna go down well in the Vatican. I've got the seizure moose and a porn star.
I'm giving birth to a Spartan. I'm pro-life.
Coming soon on ABC, seizure moose and porn star.
That's true. He's got Astro
Moose. One's a loose cannon. The other one just looks like a loose cannon.
Astro Boy.
I'm Cthulhu, so everybody who's in the Vatican right now is having like a real bad crisis.
You can't deny that. That is pretty intimidating. Cthulhu with metal claws and Vegeta.
And Vegeta. Oh my gosh, we'll be so cute together.
Like, which saga of Vegeta is this, though?
Is definitely, like, first arc Vegeta.
Just ready
to blow up planets.
Look at that tail rocking and shit.
This is Vegeta Nappa Vegeta?
This is Vegeta Nappa arc. Okay. I know he's not as strong, but this was when he was his most bloodthirsty.
I thought you would have gone for Majin Vegeta, but no?
Pictured Dan's hero is... It's literally just a porn star riding an epileptic seizure moose. That's all it is. There's no powers.
Hey, guys.
There's
here.
No powers. It's just a moose.
I call him Bleeding Gums Moosey.
Ooh. That's a good name.
Yeah, it's not a good
Kira,
however.
Oh my god, Dan.
Blood Mama, the last hairbender has it pretty good right now.
Oh god.
Yeah, the last with my giraffe that I also can control the hair of.
I feel like Grendor wouldn't be able to do much.
Here's the thing. Here's the thing. We're in the Vatican, right?
Right.
Yeah.
You can't strike down a pregnant Leroy.
on holy ground. That's true.
Yeah. I'm giving birth to a Spartan. This is like his home territory.
That's going to completely like debilitate your ability to do anything.
And then I got Astro Boy.
It's literally just Astro Boy.
It's a robot, though.
Yeah, but it's just Astro Boy. That's it.
Come on, man.
Have you seen the animes?
We're trying to work against each other. You're not trying to help everybody.
Listen, I know he's a lost cause, but I'm giving him something.
Thank you.
He's a lost cause.
I feel like Duger is the clear favorite to debuff. But it's up to the supervillain whether we start that phase or not.
All right. Yeah, I think the arguments are good.
Oh shit!
So.
That's right. Spartans were Greek. Never mind.
Grendor.
As of right now, Dodger is absolutely the strongest contender in terms of sheer power.
Was I supposed to put a sidekick down too?
No, just the players.
Ah. Oh, okay.
Or just the I mean, if you want, it's. I guess it says all players. So here you go. I'll shuffle this and. There you go.
Well, I
got
one.
Fear of Moose.
Oh,
fear of Moose.
Okay.
Fear of Moose. Yeah. Fear of Moose.
And it's Katniss.
Fucking Katniss.
Yeah.
All right,
crowd favorite.
Good job.
I mean, I'm a cowboy with a UFC champion sidekick with a super glue hose. I'm just saying.
Sticky Ricky.
Yeah.
All right. Go ahead and start the debuff phase. Why not?
All right.
All right, Dodger's
on
up
you,
first.
Dodger.
Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and take over your brain just a little bit.
Yeah.
And say that you can only move when I move.
So she is debuffing. I don't know.
Does that mean my moose can stop having a fit right now?
No, that means no. You can still control when you move. The supervillain can only move when the opponent moves, though.
So basically, that supervillain still moves all the time.
Yeah,
I can't stop.
Well, it's you're just a
True.
Moose. You're just a moose having a seizure, Dan. You're not getting it.
Oh shit!
All right, Crendo.
I'm getting it. Fine. There's a pond star on top.
I can shoot bees from my mouth.
He can shoot bees from his mouth.
So now, I don't even have to move. You'll just sit there, like, motionless as bees shoot out of my mouth and attack you.
Yeah,
that's scary.
That's really good.
But you're still giving birth, man.
Yeah.
Like...
But, like, I'm not
And so
moving.
He's going to be screaming a lot.
No,
I guess
no,
that's
not
true.
Leroy.
Wait a second. That's fucking perfect. He's not going to be moving because he's giving birth. So that means that Octopimp can't even move this whole time. He's just going to get fucked up by bees.
Shit.
Yeah, but he could turn into any vehicle, Cry. He could
can't move though.
But he could turn into a tank. Who cares about bees if you're a tank?
But he's got Astro Boy. Astro Boy can blow shit up.
Yeah.
That's true. Astro Boy can shoot lasers.
This is an easy one now.
Dude, turns out Crendor got really buff. There we go. See, there's a GG. Alright, so
I
still feel that Dodger's the most intimidating. So I'm gonna have to change her top half to be a little less intimidating.
Okay.
I mean, Cthulhu is like an all-gray and powerful being.
Okay, so...
But...
No, it's from your hand. It's from your hand, Cry.
Oh,
it's not
my
the deck.
Hands?
Not the deck.
My hands? Oh. Well, you get to be everyone's favorite fucking princess, Snow White.
Alright.
So now Dodger is... Dodger has the bottom half of Cthulhu and the top half of Snow White.
Wow, that's a prince and princess team up. That's really good.
Yeah, I've got Vegeta and Snow Thulu. Snow White.
White.
All right, on to Dan.
All right.
That's even more fucked up than it already was.
Cthulhu's getting another little debuff because...
Okay, all right.
Because Cthulhu, well, Snow White Thulu, or whatever the hell, is now really, really poorly done.
Nobody understands Cthulhu anyway.
Yeah, but you try summoning the old gods when your voice is Carrot Top. It's not going to work. It's not going to work. Cthulhu with Carrot Top's voice, that's not a thing anybody's going to be scared of. They're going to go, what the hell's this?
Okay.
Look, I still got little claws on all my tentacles, okay? Shink.
I was originally going to do this to Dodger just because she's the strongest, but I don't know. I'm just giving this to Dan for the comedic effect at this point. Dan, I'll let you flip that one over now.
Oh, God. All right, my epileptic moose with the ponzer on top is also... I can't stop.
Wow.
I'm going gonna dig a hole. Just that's all it's doing. It's
so
just
you
digging
do a
hole.
Clap, then you jazz hands. Clap, jazz hands. Clap, jazz hands. Wow. You're gonna get so tired so fast.
I don't know why it's so funny, dude.
All right.
So I think clearly I'm the winner.
Oh God.
Obviously. All right. So, Snow Thulu and Vegeta. That's an unbeatable team. That's a really good team. That's strong. Mm-hmm. But you are poorly dubbed. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I can't stand watching poorly dubbed anime, so... Mm.
But, think of it this way. My whole attack scheme is that I get into your head, right? Mm-hmm. Imagine hearing a voice in your head that is just awful.
Ugh.
Yeah, but poorly dubbed.
I'm gonna take you down
it's
mentally.
It's gonna be saying the wrong things. It's gonna be like, oh, hi guys, I'm Cthulhu, and I'll be your house dance for today. And you won't know what the hell's going
oh,
on.
Oh, no. Oh, God, that's awful.
And then but it'll be affecting Vegeta as well. He'll be like, "What's out?" And then he'll blow everyone up. It doesn't really matter. Vegeta's gonna murder us all. I think is the
rip headphone thing. Users.
I can't. I don't know how I would fight Leroy Jenkins giving birth. I can't move because he's just sitting there giving birth to a
Get
Spartan.
It.
I'm assuming a fully grown Spartan.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Boy, and he's just sitting there screaming at me while bees are firing out of his mouth.
The best you can hope for is Katniss actually does something.
And you're in the Vatican. True. You're in the Vatican. Oh, he's a holy paladin.
Yeah. Oh, dang it.
Shit, dude.
Mm-hmm. See? He's
wait.
Right
Leroy
there.
Leroy was a retribution paladin. He wasn't a holy paladin.
Oh, fuck. Fight.
He's still.
Fight.
He's still
you're
still
supposed paladin. To be WoW Krendor. You're supposed to know this Krendoge.
No.
All right, no. Never mind, touche, I guess. I would just like to say that I have no debuffs on me, and I also have a UFC champion. I think you're forgetting this, and I can also...
I also have no debuffs on me.
Yeah, I can also impede your movement, Octopimp, with the superglue fire hose and just beat the crap out of you.
I impede his sense of guilt as I am his mother, and he would never harm me. Because I raised him! I brought him into this world, I can take him out!
Oh, that's true. She is the last hairbender.
Here's the thing.
I don't know.
Here's the thing.
Katniss is gonna see red, man.
He's
Katniss is gonna just shoot you.
Katniss also has long hair, though. And, well, I mean,
I'm
just
a,
saying.
The thing. I'm a liberal.
Here's the thing, though. These.
I don't know, I feel like... Ugh, but I am armed with a PMS ray. That would throw the mom off quite a bit.
You would really use that on your own mother?
Bam!
Oh, the guilt!
That would be
the
hilarious.
Devalcho.
I did not raise you this way, Blood Moon.
Calling someone Blood Moon's not
Look,
great
mom,
on the raising
I'm
sakes.
Looking over my shoulder. I'm my own person now. I'm old enough to do what I want.
I'm going home with the giraffe.
Fine.
I Walk win.
On me just like you did me and Dad.
All right.
Oh, damn.
Octopimp. You've heard the arguments. Make your
The moose hasn't argued yet. I think the moose has a solid case.
I don't.
Does he?
There are no debuffs on this moose.
Really? Because you can't stop clapping.
I classify them more as disabilities than debuffs.
He's differently abled.
Yeah, and I brought Pawnstar along just to watch. Really, that's just the pause. I was like, I don't know what's happening right now.
You know what? I gotta give it to Leroy.
I told you, man.
I gotta give it to Krendor.
Thank you.
What?
I literally
Good
have
job,
a UFC
man.
Champion.
My father will hear about this.
Yeah, but
yeah,
he can be a car or something. What is he gonna do? How is a UFC champion gonna fuck with a car?
Oh yeah, it's Invicta. He lost.
Brock Lesnar ripped the door off a car. Quite recently. And then he threw at a child, which I found hilarious.
Did he really?
He threw a child?
He threw a car door like, and it went kind of into the crowd and hit a child.
Oh, yeah, I did see that. Yeah.
Yep.
Did the child like sustain injury at this car
no,
door?
No, not particularly. It was fine. The car door wasn't fine.
It
the car
was
door
fine.
Died on site.
So
it's fine.
Our current leaders after three rounds are Octopimp with 2, Krendor with 2, and Cry with also 2.
I feel like I'm being robbed. Clearly had superior cards right now.
Your last two. I'm whatever. Dance. Oh, thank you for going along with the clapping though. That was good. Alright, so now the supervillain is Duger.
Yeah, my calling.
Oh dear.
It did.
This is where it gets anime heavy, guys. Brace yourself.
Alright, here we go. I'll fix the cards later.
Cool.
Dun 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 dun.
All right. Whoever let's keeps, see what we got here.
Whoever keeps putting the cards sideways, I hate you.
That's probably me because I am using a touchpad and I don't know what to do. Let's see.
This isn't an anime villain. I'm gonna be disappointed.
Dan's already making his hero without even seeing the supervillain.
No, I've seen my hero.
Oh, God. If it's another moose, I'm just done.
Saw mine immediately. Might as well put it out now.
All right. Well.
What are you?
All right, guys.
All right.
I think we can all agree there's a certain person in the world who really just upsets all of us on some sort of level.
Invicta.
Justin Bieber.
Mm. That's not Invicta.
Okay.
Justin Bieber, he just does whatever he wants, thinks that, you know, nothing's gonna happen to him. But he also, because of, you know, his money, just has so many burritos. And so when he's not, you know, using his dulcet tones, he's throwing burritos at you. And Lord knows you ain't gonna attack when there's a burrito to eat.
And what is the name of your amazing supervillain that you've made?
Wait, doesn't he also get
Justin
one more
burrito.
Thing?
Yeah, but they have to name it first.
I see.
Justin Burrito.
I like
okay.
that. That's
and what is your secondary ability, Dodger?
My secondary ability is boop.
Armed with an angel arm.
Angel arm. All right,
nice.
Well.
I feel like doesn't he already have a tattoo of an angel arm or something like that? Close enough.
I think so. Yeah.
How
He's
realistic.
Got a lot of Jesus tattoos.
So you're basically just Justin Bieber then.
An angel it's just arm Justin is a Bieber weapon from that Trigun. Song.
Yeah. So. So I have an actual weapon now, but I also still throw burritos.
Okay.
All right.
I'm changing mine. Oh, I'm backing out.
Oh, the FTL music's getting good. This is going to be
a
good one.
FTL music.
Waiting for Dan.
I know, I had to change mine.
He was the first and the last to make his hero.
Whoops.
I should put effort into it. Maybe. Alright, I'm all done.
Okay. Going around
is
the room.
Everybody's stacked? Everybody's ready?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yep, yep.
Okay. Alright, Krender, you go. Alright,
I am a Republican.
Of course.
I am wearing a tinfoil hat.
Okay.
So, you're a Republican. Good.
You're basically a Republican. Got it. It's basically a Republican versus basically Justin Bieber.
Yeah.
All right. Cry.
Okay. Okay. Well, I am a bull.
Okay.
Okay.
And
a lot of animals in this game.
Yeah.
Low time when my eyes are closed.
Oh, okay. Interesting.
And my name is Boldo, not to be confused with Goldo from the Ginyu Force.
Oh.
I like it.
Thank you.
Alright.
The voice always sounds better in a ballad anyway, so I'm down for the slowing down time thing.
Chat loves your tinfoil hat, Grindoge.
Oh, wait, I didn't even name my Republican. His name will be Ronald Thump.
Okay. On to Dan. I can't wait to see this one.
I actually got a good one hand dealt this time. I am Yugi Moto, and
my
power
God.
Is I can literally talk the pants off anyone.
Oh, damn.
You want to talk the pants off Justin
off
Bieber?
Off Justin Bieber?
You know what? I think that'll be easy. I don't think I need to talk very long at all.
Yeah, it's...
Then we can get down to a nice children's card.
How did you not come up with Bullseye, by the way, Cry? I'm just curious.
I don't... Dragon Ball Z references? Dodger, of course, duh.
Gotcha.
I wish I would have gotten Kaiba.
Oh my god, that would have been amazing.
What is the
Yo
name...
move, Kaiba.
What is the name of your amazing superhero, Dan?
Yugi Moto, because Yugi Moto could talk the pants off of me anytime.
Dude, I really hope they do VR Yu-Gi-Oh, because I'll play that.
Dude, I would absolutely play VR Yu-Gi-Oh. It's like destined to do that, right?
Gotta be.
All right. I am Titan in a helicopter.
That's a big helicopter.
That's a big helicopter.
Exactly.
Simbicta, how are you choosing to read Titan? What is this a Titan from, or what type of Titan is this?
The only Titan I know of is the Titan from the Final Fantasy series, but I realize it's probably Attack on the Titan, which I've never seen, so Dodger, I'm letting you pick.
No, it's an orange card, and the orange cards are games, so...
It'd be a Tennessee Titan.
It could
No, I'm not a Tennessee Titan. I'm going...
Be anything.
I'm going with Titan from the Final Fantasy series, specifically Final Fantasy 14, I don't know.
Okay, all right.
Who was in a helicopter.
You could have definitely done a little bit of a more intimidating thing than that, but okay.
I
could have been Titan full and been the whole army.
You took my line, Dan. Took my name, man.
I know.
I was gonna name it Titanfall, but okay. Thanks. Thank you, Dan.
Well, that doesn't bode well for your helicopter. Actually, you got a Titanfall. Yeah.
All right. Is it me now?
Yep. Yes.
Okay. I am. Meme garbage. I'm a doge.
It's Gren Doge.
And I steal one attribute from opponent. I take your angel arm.
Ooh. Oh shit.
Oh,
and
my name
blew up me and the moon.
My name Damn. My name is Doge the Stampede.
That's a good one. I missed that show.
No.
Alright, let's see where we're
party.
Gonna
let's
be
all leave. This game and just watch them.
Watch Trigon?
Watch right, Trigon?
Cool. Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
All right. The restriction or situation scenario is all tribute cards disabled and characters multiplied by 100.
Wait,
what even mean?
So everyone remove your black cards and discard them, and you now are 100 of whatever your character card is.
Oh, I'm 100 balls?
Oh,
you guys are fucked.
I'm 100 titans.
I am 100 Yugi Motos.
I'll spear you.
But see, we can't beat Yugi because he is the king of games.
Yeah, now there's 100 of him. That's
gonna
give
but
you
we're
some
not,
Game of Thrones.
But we're not fighting
card.
Yugi. We're fighting Justin, 100
oh,
Justin
that's
Biebers.
True. That's the thing. True.
He would love a children's card game.
Ronald
just saying.
Thumps, dude.
And this.
Where are we fighting?
The location is a giant bounce house.
That is a huge bounce house.
This is going to be a beautiful bounce house.
It's time.
We're going to build it 20 feet wide. We're going to jump in. It's going to be beautiful. We're going to make this bounce house great again.
This is a dirty, dirty bounce house.
I'm just meme garbage, so, you know.
Okay, look.
I'm 100 titans, okay? They can do way more damage than 100 bulls or 100 Yugis.
All right, so that means that we just got to focus on Sinvicta, guys. You've got debuff cards ready, yeah, I mean... Just saying.
I say bring it on.
Alright.
Yeah, I'm feeling alright because, like, this is obviously, I mean, this is a popularity contest, right? Like, I'm more popular than all you guys, so we're fine.
I don't think you're more popular than Ronald Thump.
I'm pretty sure.
I don't think you're popular than Yugi Moto.
It's combat, though. It's
You're also in a fucking bounce house. You're screwed.
I'm gonna pop the bounce house because my horns, and we're just gonna be on a normal ground again.
You're all gonna just fall over. You have no balance in a bounce house.
Beautiful bounce house. It's gonna be impenetrable. An impenetrable bounce house. You can't break it. You can't jump over it. And Mexico's gonna pay for it.
Do you think Republicans have the ability to swagger in a bounce house and not stumble? Be like, I'm not fair enough.
It just got 10 feet thicker.
Let alone beat 100.
Argue why you would be more popular than me. That's all.
I just want to know
how
the hell are you
going to
play
defeat me.
Children's card games in a bounce house with fucking 100
Yugis. We will be using the holographic VR system that my father, who disappeared mysteriously, invented. Probably, I haven't actually seen the anime. I don't know. I just like the cards.
Kaiba made
that.
Dual disc systems, yeah.
I thought. Yeah. Oh, and Pegasus made the cards. I remember now. Yes.
I am literally 100 titans. Even while in a bounce house, I'm destroying anything and everything that I touch.
But are you having a good time in the bounce house?
I am actually crushing 100 Justin Biebers. Absolutely.
Right, but in the end, you're going to be condemned because everybody's going to be so sad that I died.
Or
like
maybe
so
the world will celebrate it, Dodger. Because you're Justin freaking Bieber.
I think they're going to look
at
you.
But here's the thing. 100 Justin Biebers all singing at the same time could explode the minds of anyone here.
Except Titan, because he's made of rock.
Mine. He doesn't care.
One of, one of them is definitely going to hit the brown note, and then you're all going to just poop yourselves.
Not if we ship you to Canada. When I'm president, we'll ship you to Canada and be done with it.
I'm pretty sure Titan wouldn't have that problem, because he's literally just rock, so he doesn't have to worry about the brown note. Bam.
I'm a meme. I got nothing.
He's just 100 Shibas just bouncing around, having fun in a bounce house with Justin
cute.
Bieber.
It's going, wow.
It's got the
wow,
cuteness factor,
wow.
I'll give it that. Minus the Justin Biebers. Alright, I think we should start the debuffing phase.
Alright.
Starting with Crindoge.
Wouldn't they be immediately discarded by the purple rule?
Yeah, let's see.
I have activated my trap card!
Let's see. We're gonna say that... Who's my biggest competition right now?
The Titans, most likely.
Yugi Moto is everyone's competition.
Alright, we'll say the Titan really has to pee.
That's not gonna affect me, though.
Yeah, it
will. You're in a bounce house. That pee's going everywhere,
but
and they're
Titan.
Gonna be so embarrassed.
He doesn't eat or consume anything, so he has no bodily functions. Because I'm Titan!
You gotta pee so bad.
You gotta pee very bad.
I'm Titan. I don't. He
really
doesn't.
Bad, dude.
He doesn't pee.
He doesn't pee.
Well, he does now.
You also don't have any bones, so I mean.
Yeah, he doesn't have any bones. He's all rock.
Have fun with that whole peeing.
He's literally rock. He doesn't.
You just gotta pee, and he got no bones.
The thing is, you really have to pee, but you can't pee.
Yeah.
You just
can't even get a boner because you don't got any bones.
He didn't have any bones in the first place. He's just rock.
He's just more bounce house for everyone.
I'm arguing against both of these debuffs.
Nah, man, you don't got any bones, and you gotta pee.
He's Titan. I could kill Bieber with just one stream.
But you can't, because you gotta pee really badly.
Yeah, and you gotta not have bones, so you can't even move yourself.
You're just
gonna
flop around in the bounce house and become
disgusting.
More bounce house. That's all it is.
The FF14 Titan isn't all rock, says Chad right there. Bam.
I'm gonna be so popular after this.
Yeah, dude.
Alright, Dan.
Dan.
Alright. Yugi Moto!
Yugi,
driving a tank! 100 Yugi Motos driving 100 Yugi. Tanks!
But you're in a bounce house.
Yeah, you're in a bounce house, though!
Yes! Tanks are all-terrain vehicles! They can go on any terrain, that includes bounce houses! The CIA tests that in some way.
Or maybe it's 100 Yugis in one tank.
No, that would be preposterous.
Yep. Wait. No, that's definitely what it is.
Eva, you don't control my universe.
Does the purple card still discard this?
It's usually house rules, so I think how I do it anyway, whenever we get a card like this, it's remove all the attribute cards at the time that this was played. So adding on after that is fine.
Yeah.
I see.
But I would argue that it's not 100 tanks, it's just one, because there's 100 Yugis. But there's only one tank now. It doesn't multiply the abilities. I'm arguing
100
this.
100 Yugis working together in harmony and unity. He's already got two in his brain. He could deal with 100. I bet it. Guarantee. Yeah.
All right, Sinvicta.
Okay. I have to figure out who I need to debuff the most, or I could just buff myself. And say that now I am also armed with red turtle shells.
Which you can't throw because you have no bones.
I won't have to. I'm in a bouncy house.
They'll just target you.
No, red turtle shells. Red turtle shells don't. They don't target the person who threw them.
But you didn't throw them.
You can't throw them. They just like.
I don't have to. They're already in the bouncy house, bouncing around with everything.
It says you're armed with them. You're there.
Yes.
They're there.
Which means that they're there with me. Means that they're all bouncing. They're already there.
But when they're hovering behind Mario in Mario Kart and he hasn't fired them yet, they're just there. They're
but
just
this isn't.
And then he's like, murder.
This isn't Mario Kart, and plus, since they're hovering around Mario
Yu-Gi-Oh!
Kart. In Mario Kart, they also act as a shield. So.
Well, in Mario Kart, there would be about three of them, and you got 100 Justin Biebers, so just three Justin Biebers to take those out, and then you gotta just have Justin Biebers punching a sack of nothing.
Yeah, but then.
You got no bones.
But then it's 97 versus 100, so there.
Yeah, things that can't defend themselves. You have no way to move yourself because you got no bones.
I'm made of rock. I have no.
You got no
I didn't
bones,
have any bones
man.
To begin
you got no
with,
bones, dude. No
and
bones.
You gotta pee, dude.
Yep. Nope. No
you
bones.
Gotta
pee.
So bad.
And
you really
that,
gotta pee.
Now this is gonna seem like a buff, but it's not. You also control a tween army, but they'll turn on you like
that if yeah. they find out they gotta fight Justin Bieber.
Yeah, you will be ripped to shreds.
Oh my god.
How dare you command them to fight Justin Bieber? They will turn on you, they will take you down from within.
100%.
I'm pretty sure even if we assume the Titan had bones and now I'm not, I'm still 100,000 tons of rock that are bouncing around with red turtle shells destroying Justin Bieber. I'm still winning this.
But you're in a bouncy house.
All right. Let's assess what's going on.
Really, okay. Nobody's going to beat the Republican Party.
So we've got our Republican friend. Who really, let's be honest, I am way more popular than you, so I'm not even worried. And then we've got the bull.
There's a Pokemon based on me, man.
There was a Pokemon based on you, but like when I cut my hair, I lost 1 million Instagram followers.
So, yeah, like, well, do you remember when you went to that brothel and everyone got all pissed at you? Yeah, I remember.
Do you know why they got pissed? Because they fucking love me. All right. Anyways, moving on.
Okay. All right.
So then we got Yugi. Yes. And let's be real. Before I was discovered, I played a little Yu-Gi-Oh. You know, I understand what's going on here, but I think there are just so many of you in one tank that it's just gonna all fall apart. So.
It's a big tank.
We've got our Titan friend. And he's armed with all of my secret agents, so not worried about that, really.
What?
And then we got the Doge. Now...
Hey, it's me, Doge.
Doge.
It's just 100 Doges.
I fucking love Doge. And...
Oh, shit.
And Doge has a form of currency named after it.
Oh, that's right. Then
no one uses, by the
way. And I love money. So... I'm kind of like, yo, what's more popular than Justin Bieber on the internet?
Memes,
fucking cute memes. Am I right? So I'm going to give it to Doge.
Yes!
One.
Boo.
Damn, all that effort.
I am disappointed.
It just lines up with my theory. Damn. The more you try, the harder you fail.
All right.
Because I changed the rules on you guys.
So the current front runner is now Octopimp with 3 points.
Get dude.
God damn.
Pulling ahead.
God. Krendor.
I voted for the Republicans in the bounce house.
Yeah.
No doubt. We were going to build a beautiful bounce house. It was going to be one of the best in the world.
It's a dirty bounce house.
Only one of the best?
All right. So Krendor is now the supervillain.
All right.
Can we take a quick pee break?
I got a pee too.
Yeah.
I was hoping someone
There's 100 titans in here that really need to pee as well.
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll take a say 5 minute break. How about that? All right, everybody. Welcome back to the co-optional lounge here. Filling in for TB, my name is Invicta, joined by Krendor, Cry, Dodger, Nerdcube and Octopimp here. TB, I did get an update. He said the pain is easing. He's on the way to the hospital. Something about a possible gallstone or something like that. So, of course, all of us wish TB a very fast and speedy recovery. And, yeah, we're sitting here playing Super Fight, Super Villain mode, actually. And currently in the lead right now with 3 is Octopimp, followed up by Krendor and Cry, both with 2 points. And the rest are just with 1, unfortunately. So the new super villain is Krendor. If you guys are ready to resume.
Yeah.
All right.
Let's do it.
Yes.
Rock and roll.
All right. So,
I will.
I just draw them, right?
No, I'll deal them up for you.
Oh, okay.
And by the way, I'm also putting TB's hands back into the deck and then reshuffling them, so we're not losing those cards.
Oh my god.
Wow.
Wow.
All right, gotta do this one, but what am I gonna put on it is the question. Hold on here.
I'm scared already.
Either this one or this one. Oh shit! Actually, all these are good.
Shit, dude. Well, While Krendor was taking his time, just in case for those of you don't know, basically it's one person's a supervillain, they create a supervillain, and the other players create a hero to counter the supervillain. All the heroes are working against each other, and everyone tries to either buff themselves, buff the supervillain, or debuff other opponents to make them more appealing for the win. And the supervillain ultimately is the judge who divvies out the points based on who they think would be the ultimate counter. Krendoj, who do we got?
All right. I am Totoro.
And
I can teleport but go blind for 10 seconds after each use.
What?
Interesting.
Poor Totoro.
Your Totoro, whose power is can teleport but goes blind 10 seconds after each use. And what is the name of that amazing supervillain?
Totoro.
Okay. Well done. And let's see what your second power is. Yeah, we don't have to keep naming if you don't want to.
Well, I mean, his name is Totoro.
Okay. And your secondary ability is?
Can't stop sobbing.
Oh, I'm so sad.
That's, oh really my God.
That's terrible.
I almost don't want to
fight you. Yeah, nobody's going to want to fight you.
That's strength. Nobody wants to fight me.
Can the battle be whoever can comfort you best?
I'll let the supervillain decide that.
Yeah, we can do that. Whoever can comfort teleporting sobbing Totoro the best wins here.
All right. Oh my God. Okay,
this
like
is the plot of a new Studio Ghibli film we're creating here right now. Oh, well, I guess I'm not going to use that one.
God.
All right, so this is a battle of love and not kill, I see.
Oh, this is the only time I've got kill things!
I know, I had a really strong kill.
The special circumstance is that the heroes are not fighting to kill, they're fighting to comfort. Yeah, is that what we're doing? Okay.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
I'm down with that.
Where's your moose with jazz hands? That would
Dan.
Oh, that's the perfect time.
Well, now I've got the ghost of an aborted fetus, so, you know, I'm on the same level. Yeah.
All right, waiting on Dan and Dodger superheroes.
All right. Okay. I've got a new idea. There we go.
All right. And after Dodger plays hers, then we'll go starting clockwise with Cry. Introducing the heroes to figure out who can cheer up sobbing Totoro.
All right, listen, teleport. I know the best thing to help out is cheering, sobbing, teleporting Totoro.
Okay.
I am the dude. And okay. I'm also 9 foot tall. I'm a very tall dude. You cannot miss me, man. I am there wherever you need me. You'll always see me in a crowd. Whenever you feel lonely, you can just teleport over to me. You'll be blind, but I'll be there to help you out. I'll show you my rug. It's fine.
All
right. And you know what? You can call me just dude because I'm so tall. Just add a few more U's to that bitch. There you go.
All right.
Right. I am Zeus.
Nothing says comfort to me
like a lightning wielding god.
Yeah, a lightning wielding god, but is going to be hilarious with a cattle prod. So instead of going like lightning death, he's like zap. Ah, look at me, I'm zapping things. Oh, I'm so swiping like little things.
That's
scary.
I think that's comedy. I feel like I would sob even harder.
Yeah.
I think that's comedy. I think there's good comedy to Zeus on with the cattle prod.
That's like dark
comedy. He
doesn't
need it. He's Zeus.
It depends what he's cattle prod.
Okay. Well, I am a child beauty pageant queen.
That's terrifying.
That's kind of scary.
Who can only move by backflipping. That's hilarious, and Totoro would love it.
That's her special
creepy
talent.
Creepy as shit.
What?
So, is this a child beauty pageant queen, like, when she's grown up, so she's a bit overweight and past her wonder years?
No, it's literally a child. It's literally a child.
Okay.
I'm imagining the worst sort of clips from Toddlers and Tiaras.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I was
picturing. Hey, you get no, you guys don't get to pick. I'm the one who decides. And I'm saying I'm the cutest, best-looking child beauty pageant queen who's backflipping for Totoro.
Hmm. Okay. All right.
Now, your sash would fall off if you backflip too much when you're the beauty queen.
No, that's why they have pins and, like, glue and stuff for that.
They glue the sashes to their skin these days.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, you know what cheers me up when I'm feeling bad? Cookies. You know what the best kind of cookies are? Girl Scout cookies. That's why I'm Girl Scout. But not only am I a Girl Scout, I'm 100 of them. So, cookies, they've got you covered.
You're supposed to be on a bounce house right now, I think. What's going on?
You're gonna
we don't have the thing this time.
You want Thin Mints, you want Samoas, you want... And we got it.
You got Dosey Dos?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Oh, man, the peanut butter ones. I'm all over the peanut butter ones.
Peanut butter, yeah.
All right.
Oh, no, those mint ones. Yeah.
Oh, thin mints? Yeah.
Thin mints, dude.
I'm not a backflipping Honey Boo Boo chat.
I'm liking this. I'm liking this. All right.
All right.
Well, Duger. I mean, I feel like, you know, sometimes when you're really sad, you need somebody who can tell that you're sad. Somebody who knows you, you know? So I'm a big old weed. I'm a big old weed, and I know
of course.
I know you. I can tell that you're real sad, you know? Mm-hmm. And just in case you think that maybe I have bad intentions, I'm actually a pinata, so you can just, like... if you felt weird. Like you needed to take me out, I'm going to share that crucial information where you could literally just murder me.
No.
If
that's
you
pretty
to.
Good. That's pretty strong right there.
Okay, so I think we found our clear debuff target.
Wrong.
No, there's no enders. Better. There's no better.
That's too perfect, man. Like
poetic justice than Oyubu getting busted open by Totoro.
Yo. All right. Well, let's find out. Let's find out exactly where we're gonna be fighting. So the scenario is. The floor is lava.
Oh, Jesus. Well, that's why Totoro is sobbing.
And we are fighting in. Soviet Russia.
And that's why.
Again.
Perfect.
All the reasons.
It's the perfect place to cheer up a sobbing Totoro.
There is no sadness in Soviet Russia.
All right. So
the lava is not going to affect me at all because I'm backflipping.
All right.
Constantly. What?
If you backflip into lava, you've backflipped into lava.
No, I'm not I'm not backflipping into like the back. Like I'm not landing like a backflop. I'm landing on my feet.
Yeah, but if your feet go in lava, you're gonna have a bad day.
Yeah, but
Zeus is literally the only one of us who can maybe fly.
Yeah, damn right. Yeah, Zeus could just stand in lava. He's like,
but he's got a cattle prod. How's that gonna cheer up a sobbing Totoro?
Yeah, but everyone here is
the only one who's
gonna
survive.
Yeah.
He will pick up the Totoro and take Totoro away. Cattle prodding occasionally, yes, because that's the card that I played. But the only way Totoro is gonna survive, Zeus.
Soviet Russia, cattle prods you.
But yeah. Totoro could just teleport to, like, on top of a building or something.
Yeah, but then he's blind and confused and falls off the building and dies. But Zeus could catch him on the way down.
But he could just stand there for, like, 10 seconds. It's fine.
What if he messes up the teleport? He wouldn't know. He's blind. And blind people have no sense.
Yeah, but he's sobbing anyway.
So I'm really, really light. So we could teleport together.
No, you would just be on fire constantly.
You would just catch on fire. No, he could pick me up and we could teleport together to
save him. That pinata is going to melt and look horrific.
It's already burned.
Being Indiana Jones, yeah, it's just melting face.
You need to get,
it doesn't matter what you look like. It matters what's inside.
And Octopimp
is melted chocolate.
Instead of
a big blob of melted chocolate and wrap it together.
Instead of
what's better to eat than a big glob of melted chocolate, thank you very much.
Yeah, excuse you.
Instead of
I'm allergic to chocolate, so clearly not
that. Totoro is not.
Yeah, but instead of one burning body, there's gonna be 100 screaming burning bodies of Octopimp. So
we'll see when we get to the button.
All right, all right,
all right.
Go for it, Karai.
Okay. Well, so I hear that you make some sweet ass Girl Scout cookies with your 100 Girl Scouts over there. I don't think you'll be able to make them with scissor hands.
Don't you do this!
That's terrifying!
Me.
I don't think you'll be able to pull that off very much, and you'll look too intimidating for Totoro.
Yeah,
to be
I was
like,
actually
I don't
leaning
feel comfortable
towards the Girl Scouts, but now this has gotten pretty
It's 100 flaming, on fire Girl Scouts with scissor hands. Perfect.
Mm-hmm.
That was a nightmare.
Well done, Cry.
Thank you.
Dan.
Next.
Nerd.
Right.
Nerd.
This pinata. This pinata.
Yeah.
He's now piloting an Evangelion.
Oh, then I'm fine.
Yeah.
I don't even worry about the lava. Awesome,
thank you. Yeah, but a pinata piloting a thing in Soviet Russia, I think that's going to get shot down pretty fast.
No, because the way that Evangelion works is it has to sync up with my brain and my emotions, so
of which you
that
have
way,
none, for no, you are just chocolate.
It would prove that I do. It would prove that I do, and then Totoro would just trust me more.
Also, Evangelion wouldn't fall to just some freaking Russian missiles, man. That motherfucker's strong.
Yeah, but it's being piloted by a pinata. You know what a pinata is? Should I draw a picture of a pinata? It's like
I made
like
that shit in second grade, man. Paper mache. It was great.
Hell
it's
yeah.
A weeaboo pinata, though, so it has feelings.
Yeah, I have a lot of feelings. And I'm there for Totoro, okay?
Thank you.
Honestly, by all standards, I think you made that pinata more adorable.
I agree. I think you buffed it.
I have nothing I can use.
You people have a strange concept of adorable.
I cannot.
Oh, it's in a massive death machine. Aww.
I literally have nothing that I can really buff anyone for, so I'm just gonna buff myself or debuff anyone with.
But you have that too.
I'm now 9 feet
tall. 9 foot tall child. Wait, that's terrifying.
That can only move by backflipping.
Scary.
Why are there two 9 feet tall? Because I also have 9 feet tall.
I know you.
Oh, wait, wasn't I supposed to draw another thing or no?
No.
Is that already what I did it for? Okay.
Yeah, you've already done
that. There's duplicates in here? Okay.
Well, you have to remember that we're using multiple decks, so there could also be like, there might be a 9 foot tall one in like one of the other decks too, so. Yeah.
All right.
Oh, God, I can't believe this. all right, well, in order to get around the lava, because, you know, we don't want to be on fire, Girl Scouts. We have 3D maneuver gear.
All right.
Oh, nice.
What?
Yeah, so we can get around the buildings.
That's smart.
What?
You got the scissor hands still, though.
Yeah, look. You might accidentally snip your wires or something.
What
know?
Is that?
Have you ever seen Edward Scissorhands? Just because they have scissor hands doesn't mean that they can't show a lot of love.
Exactly.
But what the heck is 3D maneuver gear?
It's from Attack on Titan.
Oh, okay.
It's stuff that you strap to your waist and you can fly around and, I don't know.
Are you trained in it though? You still gotta actually have training.
Excuse me. They all have their 3D maneuver gear merit badges and they earn them. So yes.
I see.
But how can you pilot anything with scissor hands?
That before the Girl Scout
because they're made, because they were born with scissor hands, so they were made to be functioned with scissor
hands.
But how is that supposed to cheer up a sobbing, teleporting Totoro?
Because you know what? They just fly over. You know what? Totoro doesn't even need to see these Girl Scouts. They will just be flying around on their, or like zipping around on their 3D maneuver gear, dropping cookies all over him. He'll be like, where are these cookies coming from? I'm so happy now.
How'd they make them, though?
And you know what? The best charity is always anonymous. So he doesn't even need to know that these Girl Scouts gave it to him.
But he goes blind.
Then he wouldn't know that he should pick you.
Yeah, he goes blind. He's not going to be able to see them.
That's not what's important. It'll make me happy to know that I cheered somebody up. And that's when I get my anonymous charity merit badge. Boom!
But how does Totoro know where the cookies came from?
That doesn't matter where he came from. He just knows that he has them.
He will look around and see where they came from, and he'll see this 9-foot-tall dude be like, hey.
Even better, would you actually
take credit?
And all the
how would Totoro see where the cookies are coming from? No, actually, well, because Totoro is going to be crying, can't stop sobbing, into lava.
Yeah.
It'll cause a lot of steam. You won't know where to aim the cookies.
Yeah, and the cookies would just
blind,
the cookies would just melt anyway.
Yep.
All right. Guys, I think, like, right now, our biggest obstacle is who is dying in this lava and who isn't. Yeah. Dude, you're huge, but you're still in the lava and you're at flesh.
Yeah.
The one that I'm really worried about is Zeus.
Yes.
Uh-huh. So, I want to just make Zeus scarier.
Okay.
So he has a chainsaw
for him. Oh, Jesus. Oh, all right. He's got a cow prod and a chainsaw now.
You ain't comforting nobody.
Nope.
Bravo. Jason Voorhees would be very comforted by the appearance of Zeus with a cow prod and chains. It's only one hand. I can put that behind my back and be like, look at my beard. I am Zeus. Oh,
but you'd still be wielding a cattle prod, though, trying to cheer up a
sobbing
Totoro.
I'm holding that in the chainsaw hand. No. I'm doing, like, wedged in the thing.
Got it in my strong hand.
Yeah, it's in the chainsaw hand. It's actually an electric chainsaw. That's what the camera's doing. It's just charging it. I cut down thunder trees. That's where I get my thunder from. Like, those things that he throws, he, like, slices them off and he uses an electric chainsaw for it. He's just come back from work. Taro's always at the bus stop. Basically, Zeus has just got off this bus and has been like, oh, I'm off work. Oh, you, I'll save you. Cheer you up. That's what's happened. You're just attacking the working man.
So, alright. Let's just break it down now. So, Cry, you're a 9-foot-tall dude, but you're in lava. You're dead.
I don't have much chance.
Dan, you are Zeus, armed with the cattle prod and a chainsaw for a hand, and I feel like that would be great if I was fighting a war, but I'm not. Next, we got Sinvicta, who again, you would just be burned in the lava, and you're dead. And then it comes down to the final two, and the Girl Scouts, they got their cookies. There's a lot of them. They got the scissor hands. They're able to move around, but I feel like when they're dropping the cookies, Totoro doesn't know where they're coming from, as we've stated. And he would see the Evangelion being piloted by the Weeb Pinata and think those cookies are coming from them. And I feel like that would make the Weeb Pinata win.
Yes!
That is all because of Nerd Cube.
Yeah, I win!
You did it.
Really, the Girl Scouts would have won if it wasn't for Dan.
Good job, Dan. You gave
I'm
it to
okay with that.
You gave it to somebody else.
Yeah, I'm okay with that. As long as I'm slightly involved in the victory, it's still a victory for
Thanks,
me.
Thanks, Dan.
Team player over here.
Oh no, but now it's Cry's turn to create a villain.
Oh yeah.
Hey.
Hi, girl.
Hi, you have come make villains here. Okay.
I'll help you out, Octopimp.
Oh, thank you.
No. Oh no.
Alright, so I should also probably mention that we didn't actually come up with a win condition. Oh. So I'm gonna let you guys figure that out.
We're gonna That's play as a 17.
Yeah.
It's a 17? Okay.
Ah, yeah, minimum.
Okay.
No.
Like maybe 30
Don't even joke about
right.
it.
So we're still going to be going till next Sunday then. I got it. All right.
Yeah.
All right. So now Cry is our supervillain. And let's find out where we go. Oh, God. I can already tell mine's going to be ridiculous.
Ooh. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Oh my god.
Wow, alright.
Oh no, I have so many anime cards and they're so fucking niche.
It's okay, I'm a fucking weeb. I might
yeah,
have you.
Luckily I'm okay. Not the supervillain, so you might be okay, Dodger.
Alright. So. I am a feral child.
Uh-huh.
Okay. I was found in the woods, and there are three of me. They are my brothers and sisters.
And what is the name of your supervillain?
Oh, you're a little litter of feral children.
We are called the Littles. There's a lot of L's in our name.
Wonderful.
Would you like to spell that?
Wonderful.
The Littles.
And let's find out what your secondary ability shall be.
The secondary ability is, of course, I'm armed with a shotgun that shoots shotguns. All three of them have shotguns that shoot shotguns.
They're shotguns that shoot shotguns.
One, two, so, six. Okay.
I mean,
okay.
Feel free to deal with these feral children that don't know any language other than their own language. And they shoot shotguns that shoot shotguns, and there's three of them. So good luck taming these wild stallions.
Okay.
That's easy. Got it. Wrap it up.
I think I'm good.
Okay.
I think I'm good. This is my
round. Oh, I'm definitely good. Waiting on.
You guys are all confident here.
Waiting on Dugu. Yeah. Yep.
Sorry.
All
right.
No, it's all right. All right. Starting with Dan
Nerdcubed,
who you
here
got?
We go. I have an alien from the film Alien or Aliens. The ability.
Or Aliens 3.
Is Mega Fighter. Left Whoa. Leg is Drogaskar. Right leg is Drogaskar.
I'm going to deal
oh
these.
My God.
I'm going
to deal me four cards, yeah, and I'll place them down.
Okay.
So this is the head. I'm actually going to draw it out. This is the
Dan,
body.
Okay.
Dan, you're actually, you're pink, right? The pink player?
Yes,
okay,
I am.
Cool.
All
right.
That's
One,
impressive.
Two, three, four. So you have to go in that
oh my
order.
God. Left
and
leg.
And
do
that
it.
My left.
Do it.
Left leg is the crocodile hunter. My right leg is a vampire slayer.
Okay.
Jesus.
Wow.
Your left arm.
This is my left arm is a gladiator.
What the fuck?
And my right arm is the queen. Oh, queen. I'm actually going to say queen feet Freddie Mercury.
The entire band
of Queen?
The entire band, yes.
All of them are formidable, and then you got Queen.
All right.
Oh my god.
They sing the celebratory song.
There's a Power Rangers reboot happening in this corner of the table right now. It's amazing.
That's already fucking game. Good luck.
No, no, we can debuff that. I still have confidence. All right, my hero. My hero.
Wait. What's his name?
Oh, God. It's, let's see, what am I? Come back to me. I'm going to make a nice anagram out of the letters Q, V, G, A, and C.
All right.
Oh, my God.
Okay, my hero is the Hulk, and my ability wants to be the very best like no one ever was. And my name is Hulk Ketchum.
All right.
Okay, I am K-pop star.
Such good music.
I hope I get to pick one. I'm going to pick Kim Jong-hyun, one of the singers from the band SHINee.
No one's going to know who that is.
I actually know who that is.
I do.
I do too, actually.
I just don't.
And he can clone himself, but the clone is half the size of the previous. He can clone his own backup dancers.
Whoa.
And they're just like progressively a little tinier as it goes.
They can stand in front of him, but they look like they're behind him. It's very clever.
That song was like Sherlock, right? That's them.
Smash Ketchum, you guys.
Is that SHINee?
They did the, what is it, the Ring-a-Ding song? That's the like the one I know.
The Dr. Dre song?
Yeah, they made the Sherlock song.
Yeah.
They did Dr. Dre.
It's Keep Your Heads Ringing by Dr. Dre.
Lucifer? I think they also did the Lucifer song.
Yeah. I think they did, yeah.
Anyway.
His name is Clone Jong-hyun.
Okay.
Nice.
All right,
Dugger. Okay.
I know that I can't fight you in the Ningenkai, in the human world, if you will.
Huh?
So I am going to drag you into the world of Bleach.
Okay.
Oh, no.
I am Ichigo, a Shinigami, the Shinigami version of Ichigo. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And I am going to drag you to Soul Society, where we will fight in the spirit realm. I also have a cell phone that can predict the future.
Oh, wow. Is that a Mirai Nikki?
So, wait, so each...
Yeah, Mirai Nikki style, so I will always know, you know, what's going to be happening.
So Ichigo is literally, he's going to literally say, oh, hang on a second, I got to check my phone.
I'm going to have my Zanbakuto in one hand, and then in the other hand, I'll have the cell phone, and I'll know what's up. I'll know how to take you down.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
So, I am me.
So Krendor is literally Krendor.
Voltron, Hulk, a fucking K-pop star, Ichigo, and Krendor.
I card to flip over and say liberal. It's what I want him on the
I'm invisible.
How's that
invisible Krendor?
How is that supposed to beat somebody in a fight?
So here's the thing. I will convince them that I am their god, because they're like feral children, right? They don't know anything.
They can't understand you.
Yeah, so I'll be their god.
But they can't understand you. How are they gonna?
How do you know?
They're feral. They don't understand like any language.
I'll bring them food, dude. I'm invisible. They'll be like, "Oh shit! This god has brought us food." And then they'll be mine.
They're not gonna have any concept of a god.
Yeah, they will.
No.
Look back at like prehistoric humans. They like worship the sun and stuff.
But you're not trying to make them worship. You're trying to beat them in a fight.
No, but I'm gonna beat them in a fight by being their god, and then I'll have them like sacrifice each other.
Damn.
There you go.
Damn.
All right. Well, let's find out what exactly is going on here. So the scenario where this fight will take place during a fangirl stampede.
Oh, I think I'm an advantage here, just saying.
You are.
On the internet.
Oh, hey.
Oh my god, that's my victory then.
Wait, so this is literally us just typing troll shit at each other and trying to hurt each other's feelings?
Oh, this is just me.
Who would win
I
in a
have
fight
no
between?
Advantage here because I'm feral children. I've never seen a keyboard. I have nothing.
Okay.
I've won.
No, it's not over. I have a cell phone that predicts the future, so I know exactly what slapback you're going to be trying to hit me with, and I'm going to cut it off.
I'm the Hulk.
Good luck, Voltron. Yeah, what did you ever decide on the name, by the way, Nerdcube?
Well, the chat decided for me. I am Exodia, the Forbidden One!
Ah,
you can't
good.
Type on the keyboard, because your hands are like people.
Well, people can type on keyboards, so I should be okay.
Yeah, but
but you're of so many minds, you can't like decide what would be the best comeback. Or
you're like a
I would argue that Queen were in perfect unison all the time. Just saying. Gladiator, maybe not, but I'll just type left-handed. It'll
so we're trying to debate. Well, I guess Cry as the supervillain. Cry, I guess, can define the winning condition here. Are we fighting on the internet? Or are you trying to out troll each other?
I like the on the internet, like out trolling each other. That'd be nice. Like however, like most defeated you can make them feel, like, you know.
Really, I've made a god over here, and that's the fight you want to have.
That's the fight. It's on the internet, man.
It's on the internet.
Internet fights are what this is.
Yeah,
man.
You can be. You could literally be that, and no one would know, Dan.
Oh, but this is during a fangirl stampede, though. So like, you got to do this during in Twitch chat.
Are we in a chat room?
You're in Markiplier's Twitch chat right now.
The chat's gonna be scrolling so fast, no one's gonna be able to see anything.
Exactly. So you're gonna have to type a lot of shit.
All right, okay. But that still gives the advantage to Dan because he's got so many appendages now that can just type.
Yep, all my limbs can type.
But it's just gonna be mumbles. It's gonna be like, because he can't.
Yeah, but it's a Twitch chat. Who knows the difference?
Take Dan down.
Ichigo is a Shinigami, but first he is a teenage boy, and he knows how to say some shit on the internet. I'm positive.
Doesn't he age by like 10 years towards the end though?
Look, he's a teenage boy. He's a sweet baby teenage boy, okay?
Yeah, that's right, Chad. I have seen Bleach. That's right. Surprise to everybody.
All right, let's begin the
buffs. All right, debuffing phase starts with Dan.
Okay, I'm going to add an ability to my character. Okay. I now shoot webs out of my anus.
What? Very, very sensibly placed as well.
Yeah,
but
that doesn't help at all.
But nobody's going to know that. How's it supposed?
I know. I just wanted to add a little bit more to this guy. Oh, he's an interesting character.
Round of applause.
Okay, well, I am going to debuff Crendoge.
What?
Who is now also riding a speeder bike. So good luck trying to type during a fangirl stampede.
Maybe, but is it moving? Maybe I'm just sitting on it.
No, you're riding it. Riding it implies
you
movement.
Ride...
Well, it what doesn't mean he's driving it, though. He could just be riding bitch.
Yeah.
No, he's riding a speeder bike. He's
I could be riding it at 1 mile an hour.
It is moving.
I'm
try typing
at
1 mile
an hour.
Very
slow.
While maneuvering through a fangirl stampede, good luck.
On the internet, though.
Yeah.
How's he supposed to type like that?
Yeah.
If he's not, he's not.
Use Siri.
No.
Also, how is he supposed to be on the internet?
Well, he's riding. He's not there. He's not with somebody. It's just him. It's him riding a speeder bike.
Everyone will get out of my way because I'm invisible.
No, you're gonna run into things. You're not gonna be able to do anything.
I'm not gonna run into anything.
Yeah, you will, because you're gonna be trying to type on the internet while still driving a speeder bike.
I'm going 2 miles an hour on the speeder bike.
He's also a baby.
He is also.
Yeah.
A baby. What? Now, how old of a baby are we talking?
1 year old.
I'm not a baby.
1 year old Crendor. Baby Crendor.
Aww. Crendor. You would have stopped Totoro crying if you weren't.
Yeah.
It, dude.
Okay, I feel like pretty much everybody has inhibited typing skills aside from our K-pop star.
No, stop this right now.
So,
oh yeah.
I'm going to say you're also 10 stories tall, so your fingers are huge.
Because I can make clones and each of this is a half the size of the previous one. So the next one is 5 stories tall, then 2.5 stories tall,
God,
and then I can just
it.
Keep going until I have an entire army of regular size
K-pop. You have to take the time to create the clones, so we'll
it
have
takes,
a, like
it
a,
happens
yeah.
immediately. It's a superpower.
No!
Yeah, there won't be any... It's still... Yeah, but that only changes the clone size, not the... Not your, Oh, I guess it would.
Have exposed testicles.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. Yeah, get him, Dodger.
Wait a minute.
Go, Duger.
Yeah. You're so uncomfortable with your testicles.
Well, then
out.
Guess what? You're handcuffed to a golf cart.
No.
So he's holding a sword and a cell phone that predicts the future, but he's also handcuffed to a golf cart during a fangirl stampede.
I'm in the chat room on my phone. Phones are really.
Wait a second. If the K-pop if the K-pop star is cloning himself over and over and over again, there's no way he's going to be able to type during the fangirl stampede that's going towards him.
No. Cloning is... The stampede is happening in the chat room.
Yeah.
The stampede's happening in the chat room.
This is happening in the Twitch chat of Markiplier's Twitch chat.
That's why this is Markiplier's Twitch chat.
I know. So I feel like...
shooting webs out my anus isn't going to do me very good.
No, not at all.
Oh, yeah. Well,
I thought that was a useful ability. Well,
Hulk has super-powered fingers. He can type faster than anyone.
But giant fingers.
Yeah, Smash Ketchum over here is going to have a real tough time.
Is actually Amish. He doesn't even go on the internet.
What? Yeah, no, they can still go on the internet.
No, they can't.
Yeah,
they don't believe in that shit.
Mm-mm. Yeah, they do. How do you think they schedule all those box socials?
Oh my god. It depends on what type of Amish you are. There are different sets.
Yeah, I'm a hippie. Hulk is a hipster Amish.
He's a Mennonite Amish. That's the one where they like don't.
Yeah, that's the one where you can't do shit.
Yeah, he's a Mennonite.
You only have candles.
I used to think they were Mennonite, and then I was like, oh, that's creepy.
Yeah, Mennonite Amish.
Yeah, the Mennonite Amish.
Well, yes,
Invicta's out of this one already.
I'm not. I can still type.
I guess it's my turn to pick the winner of this fight here. So Voltron Exodia, you had a great argument here. You're doing great, kid. Keep it up. Sinvicta, you are the Hulk who is also Amish, and.
He wants to be the very best.
You have giant fingers, but you also are Amish, so you probably have no experience with the keyboard anyway, so you would probably, like, if you could even press one key at a time, you would be, you know, pigeon-pecking each key, as it was.
Yeah.
So, but you keep hitting multiple keys at once.
He doesn't know how to type.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So that's kind of bad.
He's a scientist! He knows how to type!
No, Hulk doesn't know how to type. Bruce... No, not Bruce Banner. Dr. Banner? Was that his name?
That was Bruce Banner.
Was it Bruce Banner? Okay,
yeah.
I hope I wasn't mixing it up. Yeah. Either way, you're Hulk, not Bruce Banner. So, I mean, I'm just saying.
Yeah, he's Smash Ketchum.
You got shit going on with the keyboard knowledge right there.
That's saying that the Mennonites aren't actually Amish.
Yeah, so there. So I can't be on the internet.
Even if you are still, you're going to be slow at it.
Yeah.
That's the point.
Anyways.
Octopimp, you're rocking that K-Star pop thing going on for you there. Good job for you. You can clone yourself. That's great.
And I'm 10 stories tall.
You have those. You're 10 stories tall, and you have enormous exposed testicles. So honestly, that popularity of yours is probably not going to last too long in terms of, you know, worldwide exposure because of your exposed nuts.
Well, technically, these are just thrown out by Dodgers, so that one doesn't really
they're real.
So those aren't actually real?
No.
That was an extra one.
Threw it out extra.
I threw it out. Fine, then take back your handcuff to a cart thing.
Oh, I see. Okay. Well, and then we have Ichigo over here with his anime phone, which helps him predict the future, which is great and all. However, you don't speak English.
I don't need to. I have Google Translate.
Yeah, I speak the language of dance.
Things.
But can't the feral children not like read anything? They're just
feral children don't know.
They don't have any language.
True. Yeah. Actually, thank you for reminding me about that. And
so
then we have.
I'm gonna predict the future on my cell phone, and I'm gonna know how they're gonna react to things, and then I can adjust.
But very true.
I am like a child as well. I'm a baby. I understand that.
I speak the language of dance.
Wait, how are the feral children even supposed to read anything going on the screen?
We don't know yet.
Silly.
And then we have Krendor over here, who it's Krendor. He's invisible, like
invisible
always.
Invisible baby on a speeder
he's
bike.
He's a baby on a speeder bike. Apparently, he's going to die one of these days, probably. So here is how I will decide this. So this is all going on in Markiplier's Twitch chat, and we need the feral children even see it in the first place. So I think the only person here that would probably even get moderator to put it in sub mode so then it could actually type properly would be a famous person, being the K-pop star over here.
Hey.
Freddie Mercury! Freddie Mercury is over this side of the room!
He's dead!
Brian May is over this side of the room!
I think the fangirls would relate more to the K-pop star than...
They would, and...
he can multiply himself several times over, so he can even type multiple times on different computers. So he can continuously go ham. Krendor would have gotten mod, unless, but he became a baby.
Yeah.
So he would have gotten that Let's Play, you know, buddy mod ship, but it didn't work out because he's a baby. And he doesn't want to be fraternizing with children, because that's just embarrassing.
Yeah, dude.
All right.
Buddy mod ship. I like it.
Fire was so good for the first time ever.
So
if that was an actual fight, I would, yeah, 100% Dan would have fucking destroyed.
So Octopimp is now in the clear lead with 4 points over Dodger, Krendor, and Cry. You all have 2. Me and Dan are stuck with 1.
Yay!
This is going to be my last game. Just FYI.
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. The villain would have gone around 1 side total, so that's fine. All right. So either way, this is the this is the final round here. Since no actual victory conditions were made, it's kind of hard.
No matter what happens, I definitely lose.
But you can, affect somebody and also make them not win. So there you go.
Well, Octopimp pretty much always wins right here, though.
Yeah.
It's true. Stop.
Yeah, he has won.
We're unless all winners for enjoying each other's.
Yeah. Game. There you go.
Yay!
All right then.
Oh shit! Oh shit!
Hmm.
I have very tame cards, which is nice. Alright then.
I did not get like any good anime cards, and I'm really sad about it.
Aww.
I got one hand when Sidvicta was it. I got Sailor Moon and Vash the Stampede, and I couldn't play either. I was so upset.
Dodger, what anime cards did you get?
Fucking so good.
Oh, what was the? There was one.
Krendor, what are you doing? You don't even know the supervillain yet.
I don't need to.
Might.
Nope, I don't.
All right, Dan, who is your supervillain?
You will be up against a whale.
Okay.
That is radioactive.
Radioactive whale.
Of course. And what is the name of
the right one?
What is the name of that terrifying supervillain?
All right, good name.
And your secondary ability shall be.
Oh, please be nice. Please be nice. Please be nice. Please be murderous. 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 Murderous.
Is also really into fonts.
Oh, that's cool.
So our opponent, our supervillain, the final one of the evening, is a radioactive whale who is also really into fonts.
Now, do we mean fonts like, you know, fonts of text and typing, like, or fonts as in the things you dip a baby's head into during a baptism? Because well, we're all about those, because that's
no, it's text fonts.
I was pretty
it's
sure
it's
meant
it's
fonts.
Text fonts.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
text fonts.
Damn it. That's useless.
Bonus, what is their favorite font?
It's Comic Sans.
There you, I knew you were going to do that. I knew
it. It has to be. It's a radioactive whale.
Not going to go with Rosewood. Not going to go with...
I don't know any other. Ariel or Comic Sans, that was all you were going to get out of me.
What's wrong with Comic Sans? It's a great font.
Athletic everybody new type, Comic that's Sans. My favorite font.
Great font.
Papyrus.
Oh,
that's a tree. Shut your face.
Dude, I kept calling him Papyrus and everyone got pissed.
Pappy. It's Pappy. Pappy Russ.
And I kept saying Sans and everyone, oh man, I made so many people mad.
Comic Sans.
All right.
Comic Sans.
All right, we'll go around the room and introduce our final heroes to combat whatever Dan's, the sound that Dan made. Here we go. My hero is a reggae band, and my special ability is can only attack the opponent's genitals.
Got a big target.
Yeah,
okay,
that's a huge genitals.
Yeah. But right. The radioactive genitals as well.
Yeah, the radioactive genitals too. There you go.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
All right, mine is a Japanese schoolgirl.
Oh, dear.
Armed with a Pokeball with blank inside.
Oh, my God.
Oh. Also,
oh my God,
did Sivicta give a character card name, by the way?
Oh.
Can you name your character?
Go for the balls, man.
Good.
Oh, with a Street Fighter.
Wow. Wow.
Which Street Fighter, though?
A fighting type strong or weak against water types. I think we might have to look that up.
Oh, Blanca. Electricity, duh.
Damn.
Yeah, with Blanca inside.
What radiation?
I thought that would literally just be a Street Fighter though, not like a character from Street Fighter. It's not an orange card.
Yeah, it's just a dude on the street who really wants a Barney.
Nope, house rules. I'm gonna
house
say
rules. It's Street
you
Fighter.
Get to decide.
Bob Marley.
I like the Street Fighter character.
It's Blanca.
One.
Bob Marley and the Wailers. I like it.
Oh,
good. All right, what is your Japanese schoolgirl's name?
Let's see.
Konnichiwa.
Misty Elliott. That's it,
Misty
isn't it?
Misty Elliott. Oh,
Misty Elliott.
Oh my god.
All right, Duger.
Okay, I don't even remember what my cards were. I'm Neo. That's right.
Chosen one.
Yeah, I am. I'm Neo, and I can turn invisible if I'm singing show tunes.
You're still gonna get radiated.
Yeah. Can you imagine Keanu Reeves doing that?
I don't even need to get close. I'm Neo. Okay.
You guys have a kind of a music-focused attack on this whale, which I'm finding very odd at the moment. Whales hate music.
So
everyone
so
knows that.
But mine's an actual attack, though.
Yeah, you've got an right. actual attack.
What is the name of your character, Duger?
Oh,
it's basically Keanu Reeves.
Keanu Reeves.
Okay. It's just Keanu Reeves.
Whoa. All right. Well, I am a Japanese anime
monster. Oh, my God.
Monster.
Yes,
oh,
yes, this is a sci-fi movie in the making.
Oh, my God.
Yes, and draw and play two random attributes. From
Risky.
God.
So here's the first one. There's the second one.
All right, so what we got here, we've got is a super genius.
Oh, God.
Oh, okay.
And armed with a harpoon gun.
Oh!
Pack
it in, boys.
Over.
Pack That's it.
We're going home.
Holy shit. That's the power card so
wow.
hard.
Coming wow. soon to Sci-Fi Channel. It's a Japanese animal porn tentacle monster hunting a whale.
Oh, I don't even need to play my shit.
All right,
squiggles.
Cry.
Squiggles.
On to Cry.
Well, I'm the UN.
Okay.
And
I'm in
a berserker rage.
They're gonna get rid of. They're like, whaling is totally legal now. That's their thing. That's what they're gonna do.
And what's the name of your superhero Cry?
The Un.
Great. Well done.
All
right, well, let's find out exactly where we're going to be fighting, because someone needs to get nerfed badly. So the situation, scenario is... The fighters are armless!
Oh, wow. House rule, can that include tentacles, please?
Yes, it will.
Yes!
Yes, it does.
Oh, that means the Japanese schoolgirl can't even throw the Pokeball!
No.
Okay.
Oh, no, I got this.
And... the location is the Middle Ages.
Where wow. whales reign supreme. The whale doesn't get debuffed because he doesn't have any arms. This is a difficult fight.
Oh, no.
Downside, no faults
so,
in the Middle Ages.
If you have...
The only reason I don't have arms is because I'm in the Matrix and you're making me think I don't have arms, but it's all good.
You definitely don't have arms.
Would the whale be able to ever turn if he doesn't have any arms?
No, the arms. No, the arm have... The arms... The whale has arms fine, I think. Fighters are armless, so, I mean, whales don't have arms. They have fins.
Yeah,
but if we're saying tentacles are arms, aren't fins technically arms
well?
Well,
yeah, I guess...
Fins can't grip. Fins can't really grip. You know, tentacles, they're all army and grippy. Fins are, like, just, like, scuba majigs.
Nah.
I think you're trying to stretch that, man. I think
no,
you got
Dan,
arms,
Dan,
man.
You know what?
Dan.
I will lose my fins because I want to just laugh at that tentacle-less tentacle monster.
Yeah, Dan.
So it's literally just a harpoon gun at this point.
Arms.
Yeah,
they're not
Dan,
arms.
Dan, if you cut off the tentacles, you also have to cut off your fins. That's the situation.
I'm doing that.
Okay.
I'm fine with that.
Okay, okay,
I'm
okay. And we're fighting in the Middle Ages. All right.
Here's the thing. I can shoot the harpoon gun with my mouth. I'm a super genius.
How are you gonna? No, no.
Super
that doesn't matter
that.
How smart you are. You can't pull a trigger with like your mouth. How are you gonna aim it?
I did that all the time. It was his
I think with
trick.
Time you could finagle it, but you don't really have time.
You know who else is a,
yeah,
super,
I'm a
genius?
Super genius?
Stephen Hawking, and he can't shoot a harpoon gun.
Exactly.
So
exactly.
If he wanted to, he could.
Wow. That's wow. Okay. Wow. If anyone's ever gonna animate this episode, don't animate that bit. Let's be nice. Don't even go there.
Do animate that.
Yeah, please do animate that.
Oh my god.
There's no way you'd be able to finagle the harpoon gun like that.
There definitely is.
I still have abilities to attack the opponent's genitals, so I'm still good with that. I need to debuff. I mean, the only person here that still is like somewhat effective, also in the lead, is Octopimp. Because even though the Japanese schoolgirl doesn't have any, even though she doesn't have any arms, like, I assume that we could, that she can still deploy the Pokeball, correct?
What?
She
just,
yeah. Well, has to throw a Pokeball.
Like shoot a harpoon gun. You can't throw a Pokeball.
Hey, yep. We all know the relationship between Japan and Wales, so let's just put that out there.
Wait, there's no rule that says they have to throw. They could easily like hacky sack a Pokeball
too. There's more. Don't worry about it. There's more. Don't even give me. We'll say that I can't throw the Pokeball. Just wait till the buff phase.
Okay. Well, I'm going to debuff Octopimp. The only way that I know how, because he's in the lead and I need to win one. So Octopimp, you are now killed by water.
Okay. Okay.
Wow.
Gonna be a difficult fight against a whale.
You know what? That doesn't matter. I can use the force. I don't even need to throw that Pokeball.
Oh.
I can just throw it with my mind.
But you're killed by water.
Yeah, but I'm not the one fighting it.
Wait, no, like, Krendor is not. Krendor is not you. It's not you. It's Dodger first.
What? No.
Yeah. Okay. So I think that if the entire UN was armless and running at me, I would be scared. So.
But it is the Middle Ages. So they're not that a big force.
They don't even exist.
No, they don't actually. That is just a car that doesn't exist.
They're in a hot air balloon now.
Which wasn't invented yet.
Oh. The UN is in a hot air balloon now.
Yeah.
Without arms in a berserker rage. Oh.
If you try to jump down, you can't really like adjust it, so it's just going
to
keep floating up.
You're just
going to
fall to your
death.
So
you're going to have to decide to just jump out, but you'll die, so.
Oh. Wow, that sucks. That's just I don't have any nuke buttons up there either. All right,
Krendor debuffed Octopimp with is walking 12 kids on leashes. Good luck.
Kids to be walking.
Good luck trying to avoid water while you're doing all of that.
Hang on, if you're walking 12 kids without arms, where are the leashes?
I'm not fighting the whale. Blanca is, so it's whatever.
Okay, but seriously, the leashes, what you got them around your throat? Kids will just run in 12 different directions and you'll die.
No! Wouldn't the sidekick's job be to do the stuff the hero didn't want to do, like walking 12 kids on a leash?
That sounds right.
I rest my case. Blanca is,
he's not
indisposed
sidekick,
at the time.
He's my poke fighter.
He's indisposed of at the time.
Well, I think we're all missing the fact that, you know, Dodger can turn invisible, but she can't turn this red shirt invisible.
Oh,
kind of fucking useless now, if you ask me. Just saying.
So it's an armless Keanu
Reeves. All colors look good on me. Also, I'm Neo, so I can still just like control bullets and shit.
True, but your invisibility powers is just definitely not really in the mix anymore.
That does kind of cancel that out.
Okay, that's fine. Look, I'm gonna take Krender's harpoon and shoot it with my brain.
So I win.
So that means he wins.
Let's team up. Krender, you want to team up?
No, they can't.
You can't team up. There's no team up.
Wait a minute. It's the last game. Cool. Let's team up.
Yeah.
I'm the only one who actually has an attack that can still win. I want to point that out, Dan.
No.
Yeah. How are you guys supposed to beat a whale?
You can't. How are you supposed to get to his genitals if he's radioactive?
I've got feet.
I am the epitome of the UN. I can drop our entire body.
It's
like
the
mass.
Middle Ages.
Exactly.
It's okay.
Reggae.
We'll get there.
Reggae bands still existed.
Okay.
And Neo also didn't exist in the Matrix, or in the
I don't think Reggae did either, but I can't hold their instruments, so it's not a problem. None of you exist or have arms. This is incredibly difficult.
I still think that Octo would win. I still think that he's the biggest
I can stick the kids
threat.
On the whale, I'm just saying.
Well, you can use the Force to hold all of their leashes, so
but
I don't
is
think,
he trained
that's,
in
I
the
think
force.
That's like a non-issue.
He's like a teen Japanese girl.
Yeah, it uses the force, not even can use the
you
force.
You can't use the force if you're official. Dead. You also can't throw a Pokeball if you're dead.
Yeah, so
why
I just
would
don't
you
go
be dead?
Near the water.
You're fighting a whale!
Yeah, Blanca is fighting a whale.
Blanca's
a radioactive whale.
How is he gonna deploy Blanca if he's dead?
What?
All right, Sinvicta, even...
You're dead! He's dead!
He's not making the mental leaps we need him to make right now.
I don't have the mental gymnastics to go with the same reasoning that you do.
Force ghost.
Shall we do a recap of everyone and sort this out? Right, first up, we have a reggae band before reggae was invented who don't have arms, so can't play their instruments, who can only attack the opponent's genitals. I've got a big target on the genitals, but you will be having to headbutt whale penis for quite some time.
Radioactive
underwater.
Whale penis.
Yeah, I wonder if you'd actually be able to headbutt a whale to death via its penis before you die of radiation. Difficult. That's a difficult one. Unsure of that one. All right, over here we have a complete mess of 1,000 things. This looks like a fan fiction in this corner. It's an armless Japanese schoolgirl who uses the force, killed by water, is walking 12 kids on leashes, armed with a Pokeball with an electric type inside. That's quite strong, but 12 kids on leashes, that they're not your kids because you're a schoolgirl. You're walking those kids. You're going to want to keep a focus on those. I think the focus is going to shift away. I think that you won't be focused on the battle and
yeah,
it will go wrong.
I'm
you'll
not,
be killed
good thing
by
I'm
water.
Not fighting the whale, so...
Yeah, but you're trying to fight water and kids will just spit on you. Kids do that. Kids are pricks. Basically, you got kids on your side, you can't win.
Might I interject really quick before we get to Dodger? I think I accidentally buffed her a little bit because we forgot. You are into fonts and I gave her an Aeropostale shirt. So there is a sweet logo right on the front of a red shirt that you might get really into. You may be like, oh man,
that's
a nice
true.
Font.
But so, we all know the rule. Anyone wearing a red shirt dies first. So unfortunately,
oh,
Neo will
that
immediately
is true.
Die.
Unless immediately. You're Scotty.
Unless you're Scotty, in which case you'd get stuck in
guess
the transport
what?
Thing
I'm
and end up in Next
Scotty.
Generation. No, you're Neo. He's not Scotty. That's not a thing that happened. God damn it, I'm a Matrix person. I haven't seen the Matrix. So we come to a Japanese anime... Anime, I'll say that right. Porn tentacle
anime,
monster.
Yes.
Anime.
It's just a
Japanese anime
stump.
Porn tentacle monster with no tentacles, no way of firing a harpoon gun, but is really smart, but somehow got themselves in this position. And the UN, which don't exist in the Middle Ages. So!
I'm an idea.
I think the closest anyone has to beating a whale to death is via its penis. It's the reggae band! The reggae band
yeah.
all the way!
Yeah!
You win the trophy. This is now a trophy.
I get a point.
Wait, shit, that means I absolutely lose!
You always-
Yeah, last place.
You had no shit getting a point.
Dan, I give you my point. We did an extra round, you get a point too. There you go.
Yay! Everybody, I win the sympathy round!
There you go. Alright, everyone, that is going to do it for the co-optional lounge. Thank you for watching. We'll go around if everyone wants to plug their stuff, starting with Crendoge.
Twitch.tv/Crendor, Facebook.com/Crendor, Twitter.com/Crendor, YouTube.com/WowCrendor. Buy my shirts, buy my stuff, do everything, yeah, blah, 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 blah.
All right, then Cry, who doesn't plug his stuff, but we're going to make him anyway.
Hey, head over to Jinx.com and use the coupon code CRACK for 15% off your order.
There you go. And next up is Dodger.
Oh, me?
Yeah.
Hi, everybody. I'm Dodger. I play dumb dating sims. Come hang out. Press R to continue.
There you go. And then next up is, in proverbial, always second place with me, Dan Nerdcubed.
Hello, I am Nerdcubed. If you go to official Nerdcubed on YouTube, I'm currently playing through the absolutely atrocious Sonic 06. We're going to see if I can finish it before it finishes me.
All right, and Octopimp.
Hi, I'm Octopimp. I do anime bullshit on the internet. I do a show called 50% Off. It's about cute boys taking off their shirts and getting in the pool. YouTube.com/Octopimp. That's me.
There you go. And my name is Sinvicta. You can find me streaming Wednesday through Saturday, twitch.tv/Sinvicta. Check out my YouTube, youtube.com/Sinvicta316. Thank you for watching, everyone. We'll try. I'm sure TB will also give us another update. So, of course, fast recovery and warm wishes to Total Biscuit. Hope he's feeling better today. So, again, thank you all for tuning in. I do appreciate it. This will be up on my YouTube. You can find all the links down below to everyone's channels out there. And, of course, we'll see you all next time. Thank you to all of our guests. Thank you, TB, for the host as well. We'll see you all next time. Yeah. Good night, everybody. Thank you for watching.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.